right, we're ready for the Class 3A title game. The DuQuoin Indians on a postseason roll heading into tonight's action. And then the other team, a great story, Immaculate Conception, down in recent years, not so this year. They're ready to roll. All right, and welcome to Memorial Stadium. We're just a couple of minutes away from the 3A title game, the last game of the first day of action. And this shapes up to be a very interesting matchup. The DuQuoin Indians playing very well in postseason play, facing Immaculate Conception out of Elmhurst. Elmhurst, Immaculate Conception, they've only lost one game, and that was to Driscoll Catholic, who just a few minutes ago wrapped up winning their second consecutive 4A state championship. So this shapes up to be an interesting game. And I'll tell you what, the guys are going to call the game. I think they're going to have a lot of fun. I know they did earlier in the day. Let's send it upstairs to Jim and Steve.
All right, thank you, Mike. Mike, we've got a great matchup here today in the 3A final, in a North versus South matchup. In a state like Illinois, it's always nice to have that kind of North versus South rivalry. We certainly have that with DuQuoin and Immaculate Conception.
Exactly right. You've seen DuQuoin year after year making it here in the 3A state championship. Immaculate Conception, first time in a while. And I know they're really looking forward to it. Went up and saw that Wilmington game they played in the semifinals. They are very jazzed up. They have a lot of talent. It should be a really good game, Jim.
Not only do we have North versus South, we also have power versus speed. DuQuoin is big, they're athletic as well, but Immaculate Conception, they are built on speed, Steve.
Well, that's what we talked to Al Martin, the head coach of DuQuoin, about. He's really worried about their speed. Immaculate Conception, speed everywhere. On the wideouts, at running back, at quarterback, you're going to see a very good quarterback on both sides of the football. We'll talk about them a little more as the game goes on, Jim.
Let's take a look at how these teams got into this title game, meandering through the playoffs to get to Memorial Stadium and play in this title game. There you see DuQuoin defeating Chester, Marshall, Anna Jonesboro, and Monticello, steamrolling their way to this title. Their starting defense has allowed one touchdown in the playoffs. That's amazing.
That's amazing. You see a lot of points scored there as well. They're very high-powered offense.
And then for Immaculate Conception, they're pretty impressive as well getting here. In the semifinals, they had to knock off an undefeated Wilmington team on the road. You saw that game. They were impressive in doing so.
They really were. That was not as close as that final score ended up. Wilmington ended up getting a running back get injured, but Immaculate Conception, very good, Jim.
Let's look at the key players for this ball game today, and we're going to see some special ones. You look at DuQuoin, there's Nick Hill.
Well, I think he's just fantastic. You can see his stats right there. He's a big kid as well, 6'3", 187. Very good athlete. We know he's a very good basketball player as well. Fantastic player, and he's really a catalyst for them.
And on defense for the Indians, they're going to go with one of their big defensive tackles, Matt Beckman.
Yeah, we had to stay with him. He's got to be able to stop the run from Immaculate Conception and find a way to get to the quarterback. Anthony Schreiber will move around a little bit. They've got to get to him, and Matt Beckman's going to be one of them that's going to have to.
You mentioned Anthony Schreiber. He's one of the key offensive players, the quarterback, a left-hander for Immaculate Conception.
Yeah, we'll have two lefties this evening in our game, and he's put up some very good stats. Doesn't get a lot of praise in the Chicago area. A lot of good quarterbacks up there, but I'll tell you, he's a special one.
And on defense, a key player for Immaculate Conception, you look there, it is Brian Kowiski, and that's a big boy there.
That's right. That's not exactly a picture of him right there, but I think we wanted to highlight Bill Bianchi, actually, and Bill is going to be the guy we're going to talk a lot about, 6'4", 350. He's a run stopper up the middle for him.
Well, let's meet the starting lineups for this ball game between the Knights and the Indians. For that, we go to Memorial Stadium. Public address announcer, Jeff Fritzen.
Yeah. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here are the starting lineups for the Class 3A State Championship. First, from Elmhurst, Immaculate Conception, Coach Bob Cozy. The starting defense for Immaculate Conception at end, number 64, Bill Kreft. At tackle, number 50, Patrick Gibbons. At tackle, number 61, Bill Bianchi. At end, number 75, Matt Jaswick. At linebacker, number 11, Kevin Mulligan. At linebacker, number 22, Brian Kowiski. At linebacker, number 88, Pat Groby. Cornerback, number 2, Joe Mastrino. At safety, number 21, Nick Navarroski. At safety, number 5, Mark Ressio. And at cornerback, number 44, Gabe Murphy. For DuQuoin, Coach Al Martin. And the starting offense at quarterback, number 17, Nick Hill. At fullback, number 31, Cole Indris. At running back, number 28, Robbie Tilly. At running back, number 23, Derek Beard. At center, number 57, Matt Darnell. Guard, number 68, Chris Ridgway. At guard, number 61, Cody Edwards. At tackle, number 72, Zach Calvert. At tackle, number 77, Luke Scaglione. At tight end, number 80, Jordan Campanella. And a split in, number 7, Terrence Spiller.
Back up here in the booth at Memorial Stadium in Champaign, just moments before the kickoff of the state championship game in 3A between DuQuoin and Immaculate Conception. Let's look at the keys to this ball game for both teams. As you see some of the DuQuoin players getting ready, there are some keys for DuQuoin, Mr. Mays.
Obviously,
dissect them, please.
King of the Hill, we've talked about him, and they're going to be their quarterback. He's fantastic. Watch him, number 17.
Nick Hill,
time of possession. Obviously, they're going to have to keep the ball out of the hands of Immaculate Conception. Look for them to run a little double wing, a lot of misdirection, and limit the big plays. When I watched the game last week, Immaculate Conception in Wilmington, boy, Immaculate Conception had a lot of big plays. They've got to limit those tonight.
Yeah, last week, Immaculate Conception scored on pass plays of over 50 yards twice in the ball game against Wilmington. Now the keys for Immaculate Conception.
Yep.
Number one is obvious, speed kills.
One of the fastest team you'll see in 3A, speed everywhere. We talked about that in the 1A game. We did a lot of speed for South Beloit, but I'm going to tell you, you're going to see a lot of speed here, Immaculate Conception. They got to mix it up. They like to run it a little bit and get Schreiber out outside and run, and then they got to stop the run. I mean, DuQuoin's not going to hide anything. They're coming right out, and they're going to try and run the football on it. They're going to have to stop it tonight.
All right, so DuQuoin is going to get first crack as Immaculate Conception just about set and ready to kick it off. Immaculate Conception finished in a three-way tie for first place in the Suburban Catholic Conference with Driscoll and Lombard Montini. Driscoll, of course, winning the 4A title in impressive fashion earlier tonight. DuQuoin, champions of the Southern Illinois River-to-River Mississippi Division. The kick bounces and it is fielded at about the 5-yard line. On the return for DuQuoin out to the 21 before he is swarmed under. That's where DuQuoin will take over off the 16-yard return by Cody Ellemeyer of DuQuoin. There you see him running to the sideline. So DuQuoin will come on the field led by their all-state quarterback, Nick Hill. Hill has already signed on to play Division I college basketball. at Western Kentucky. Not a bad basketball program to be going to.
Top 20 program this year, top 10 program actually, so he must be quite a basketball player. Haven't seen him play, and looking forward to seeing him play a little football tonight. Perfect night for it, Jim.
Two receivers in an I formation here on first down as Hill takes, and it's Robbie Tilley, the tailback. Tilley surges out across the 25 to about the 27. Tilley on the season has rushed for 959 yards. Last week in the semifinal victory over Monticello, he rushed for 142 yards. And right now, let's go down to the field. Mike Kleff is standing by. Mike, what do you have for us?
Well, Jim and Steve, just a real quick point. I was talking to one of the staff members on Immaculate Conception just a moment ago, and he just gave a deep breath, and he said, now we can finally relax. We're finally playing. And the point I know you guys will talk about, hey, these guys have had to wait around a long time today. Nerves are going to be more than the other teams earlier in the day.
Derek Beard with the carry. Thank you, Mike. And DuQuoin has been here before. This is Immaculate Conception's first trip to a title game. You know, I don't know. Does that mean anything right now as we just saw Beard rip off a good run for DuQuoin to get a first down?
You know, we got to remember these are 17, 18, 19-year-old kids. It's hard to tell. It's a new group of kids. Al Martin trains his team the same way year after year. So maybe he has, from a coaching perspective, a little more experience. But the players, they're all new, and it's a whole new group of kids. So
DuQuoin, a couple of running plays, and they come up with a first down. Out of the eye, they're going to give it to Robbie Tilley, surging forward behind those big offensive linemen. DuQuoin has a couple of 300-pounders up front. Chris Ridgway, 348 pounds, and Zach Calvert, he weighs in at 300 pounds. He's small compared to the other guy.
Yeah, Ridgway goes 6'6", 348, so he's a big kid. We saw him down in pregame warm-ups. He's a real big kid and actually can move a little bit. Got nice size all the way across the front, and Immaculate Conception's going to have to contend with that all evening tonight.
Second down and six. Make it five upcoming for DuQuoin. The Indians moving against the wind here in the first quarter of the ball game. They show the eye. Now Hill, the lefty, throwing deep. He's looking for Spiller. Spiller makes an adjustment, and he makes the catch. No, they're going to say it's incomplete. Boy, a great athletic effort by Terrence Spiller. He almost came up with it. Are they going to overrule
him? Boy, I think they gave it to him, yeah.
They overruled. Initially, the official said incomplete, and now they've changed their mind, and they said it's complete. It's a 34-yard pass play. Hill to Spiller, and DuQuoin is moving.
Well, he came in here as his favorite target. 30 catches, 750 yards, 8 for TD, so he's quite a player. And you got a little look at here, right here, of Hill's arm. This is just a nice throw, one-on-one on the outside, Jim. And look at the catch by Spiller. That's just fantastic. He might have been juggling that ball a little bit.
I don't know. DuQuoin might have got the benefit of the doubt on that one. So first down for the Indians nonetheless. And they give it up the middle. Robbie Tilley with the carry. Talking about Nick Hill and some of his numbers at the quarterback position, as you see Mr. Hill right there. 1,451 yards passing. He's completed 52% of the balls that he's thrown. 19 touchdowns, just one interception all season long, and he's rushed for 11 more touchdowns.
Yeah, that's pretty amazing, the one interception. The 19 touchdowns is not too exciting, but the one interception is pretty amazing. Usually, as a quarterback, you have a couple tip balls, a drop ball that'll go into the defender's hands. He hasn't had any of that this year.
Beard with a big carry to the 20-15. Beard is wrestled down as he gets to the 10-yard line. A pickup of 16 for Chris Beard and a first down for the Indians.
Well, very impressed by the offensive line for DuQuoin right now, just handling him up front. As you see the offensive line, we're going to get a chance to see the replay one more time. Great angle right here. Look at that surge by the offense. Getting to the linebackers, that's the thing. They're going onto the next level. Big carry right there down to about the 10-yard line.
So DuQuoin up to the line of scrimmage. It's first and 10 just inside the 11. They go to the wishbone. They give it to Tilley, trying to get off left tackle. He's near the five, and boy, an impressive drive for DuQuoin. Right now, they're taking advantage of their size up front.
Exactly, and that was the one concern from Immaculate Conception. They saw on paper, DuQuoin, boy, they're pretty physical, but can they move? Well, they're getting after it right now. They just went to their base offense. They like to run on goal line, two tight ends and a wishbone backfield. They like to just mow you over when they get you inside the 10-yard line, Jim.
Second down and five for the Indians. There you see the matchup. A lot of Immaculate Conception's size is in one guy, and that's Bill Bianchi at 350 pounds. The other guys for IC aren't all that big. Carry up the middle goes for a couple of yards as Cole Endres carries out of his fullback position for the Indians. There you see DuQuoin courts
coach Al Martin in his 15th year at DuQuoin, and DuQuoin in the playoffs for the 19th consecutive year.
Isn't that amazing?
Trying to win their third state championship.
He just gets you pumped up when you talk to him. We talked to him pregame, and he got me fired up talking to him. He's excited about this game.
Hill on the keeper is going to be dropped. We're going to see a fourth down call coming up for the Indians. Boy, an impressive drive here for DuQuoin. Has stalled out inside the 10, and let's see what they will do here on fourth down. It's going to be marked at the 6, and it looks like they're just going to go ahead and go for it.
5 to 6 yards.
You see Nick Hill in the huddle, slapping some heads, trying to get his offense fired up. The first big play of the ball game is coming up, and before that big play, we're going to have a timeout on the field. 7:31 left to play in the opening quarter. DuQuoin facing a fourth down and 5 at the 6-yard line deep inside of IC territory.
I think we're going to get a chance to see the last play that DuQuoin ran. Went back to their wishbone, two tight ends, and you're going to see the linebackers fly around. Look how deep those linebackers are from Immaculate Conception, but they can really run and fly to the football. And there you see just stuffing that one. You know, and now fourth and short for a touchdown.
You look at that play, and the Immaculate Conception defense, they didn't respect fullback at all. Endress came clear.
Right, untouched.
And, untouched. He would, if they would have given the ball to Endress on the first option, he probably would have scored a touchdown.
Right.
But everybody went after Hill on the keeper, and now DuQuoin faced with a 4th and 5. Now they can get a first down inside the 1.
Right.
So they don't have to get in the end zone, but there isn't much room between the first down stick and the goal line.
Well, I think you got to watch out for Terrence Spiller here. They got him spread out here down at the bottom of the screen there. Remember that Hill is a lefty quarterback. Look for him to come out here and throw to Spiller.
Hill looks to throw, looking to the end zone. It's caught for the touchdown by that man, Terrence Spiller. It's a touchdown for DuQuoin as they convert on a big 4th down and 5 to take the early lead here in the Class 3A state championship.
Well, you could just see it from up here, couldn't you? Too bad we couldn't have yelled down to the Immaculate Conception coaches, but you could see Spiller out here isolated. We're going to get a chance to see that one more time. Spiller's on the outside here. You see him right there. He's just going to make an inside move and then back to the outside. And look at Nick Hill just locates him. That's an easy touchdown. Gutsy call, like you said, on 4th down.
And the conversion kick, there you see Derek Beard just kicked the conversion, and DuQuoin has the lead 7-0 with 7:26 left to play here in the first quarter. DuQuoin to put it back in play, leading 7-0 after a 10-play, 79-yard touchdown drive, capped off by a 4th down pass from Nick Hill to Terrence Spiller. Derek Beard with a squib kick. They want to kick away from Immaculate Conception's speed. And on the return for Immaculate Conception is Jack Campbell. And let's go back and look at that 4th down play, Nick Hill to Terrence Spiller.
Going to see Nick Hill, a little play action, freeze those linebackers. Look at that form. I'll tell you, that's nice. That ball's tight. Spiller's just all alone. Good call. He's a nice receiver. We saw him in warm-ups. He's tall kid, tall, rangy, and fast.
Spiller's 9th touchdown reception of the year. And now Immaculate Conception will go to work with their All-State quarterback, Anthony Schreiber. He's going to run some play action, and he's going to throw. The pass is dropped. The pass intended for Kevin Mulligan, number 11. It came up empty. There you see him there. And 2nd down and 10 coming up for Immaculate Conception. We mentioned that DuQuoin is playing in the title game for the 6th time, for the 5th time under Al Martin. These guys have been in this situation before. In preparation, maybe DuQuoin has an advantage of getting ready for this game, but I think, you know, once you get on the field and start playing, it's equal. Do you
that,
agree?
I agree. Yeah. That all goes away and it's equal. You know, like we said, new kids, the coaches, it helps them, but I'm not sure it helps the players so much. Maybe in the preparation it does.
They give it up the middle to the fullback, do the Knights, and that is Campbell carrying for Immaculate Conception. Good gain on the first option of the triple option, and it's going to bring up 3rd down and about 4 for the Knights.
Well, you got a nice block by number 51, Ryan Zarante, getting off the football, knocking people around. I'll tell you, this is kind of a situation right here, 3rd and short. They like to roll the quarterback, Anthony Schreiber, out, get him out on the outside, and give him the option of running or throwing.
So we see an I formation in the backfield behind Schreiber, and Three receivers, two right and one left. They toss it left on the carry. Gabe Murphy, penalty flags on the play. Murphy is not going to get the first down. Let's check the flag, but right now let's go down to the field. Mike Kleff has got a report for us.
Steve, just real quick, Nick Hill, you've been talking about him and Jim at the top of the telecast. You said that he's actually going to Western Kentucky on a basketball scholarship. As we can tell, the DuQuoin quarterback throws the ball left-handed, but in basketball, he shoots the ball right-handed. So as this game develops, I think we'll see that he uses both hands often and very well. Back to you guys.
He's ambidextrous, too.
Well, I want to see him throw one right-handed, too. Roll out to the right and throw it right-handed. I'd like to see that.
Holding, blue, 10-yard penalty, repeat third down.
That was Gary Henson, our referee for this Class 3A title game. And there's our officiating crew. These guys are out of the Metro East area near St. Louis. And again, Gary Henson will be our referee. We'll hear from him as the night progresses. So after the penalty, we're going to have third down and a little bit more than 10 here for the Knights.
You will see Schreiber go into the shotgun a little bit as he does right here. They like to do this on anything where it's third and long, second and long, that type of thing, and sprint him out.
There you see Schreiber, the lefty, rolling and tucking and running. Schreiber is not going to get the first down. He goes out of bounds short of the first down marker and a fourth down situation. And the Knights will probably punt here. 5:59 left to go in the opening quarter. DuQuoin scored on its first drive, and the Indians hold Immaculate Conception on its first drive.
Well, I tell you, the one question mark we had about DuQuoin is what kind of speed they have. So far, Jim, they've shown a little more than you and I thought they had. They've been able to keep everything in front of them. They've done a very nice job, as now, once again, Immaculate Conception will be forced to punt.
And Jazwiak is ready to punt it away. Matt Jazwiak, wearing number 75, stands at his own 30. Ooh, the kick is away and was nearly blocked by Campanella. He blocked one last week and it was tipped. It was partially blocked by Jordan Campanella. He had a punt block in the semifinal win over Monticello last week. It is just a 16-yard punt, and Campanella going high. We'll see the replay maybe in a little while. He did get a piece of it.
He did, with his right hand, no doubt about it. We got an excellent replay on this one. Watch number 80 come in from the outside. He's going to stretch out that big right paw. This is good coaching right here. Anytime you get near, just lay out for it. Campanella does a great job, gets a piece of it. Now they have great field position one more time.
So here come the Indians up to the line of scrimmage. They start from their own 41. Robbie Tilley, good yardage up the middle. Tilley out to about the 48. It's going to bring up second down and short.
But Robbie Tilley's not very big, only 5'10", 177, but man, does he run hard. He should break the 1,000-yard barrier tonight. As the night progresses, we'll have to keep everybody posted on that. Right now, he has four carries for 32 yards. He's quite a back.
Tilley battling a sprained ankle earlier, late in the regular season, early in the playoffs. He is fully healthy now, and that's one of the keys that Coach Al Martin is looking at. He feels that this is as healthy as the team has been in a long time. Give to Derek Beard, I believe, the ball carrier.
Yeah, going back to that issue of being healthy, when you asked Coach Martin if everybody was healthy, he kind of got that big smile on his face. You know, at this time of the year, you've got all these nicks and bumps and bruises and all that, but he had that smile, and it's kind of an indication everybody's healthy for this game. That's a good sign for them.
Beard picking up first down yardage for the Indians. DuQuoin, four first downs so far, none for Immaculate Conception. Total yards right now, 91-12 in favor of DuQuoin. And we've got a stoppage of play, an official's timeout. With 4:53 to go in the opening quarter, Jim Spencer, Steve Mays, Mike Kleff here at Memorial Stadium in Champaign for the 3A title game, already winning today in 1A. Alito in 2A. It was, in 1A it was South Beloit, in 2A it was Alito. In 3A, we're playing right now, and in 4A, Driscoll Catholic, penalty flags on the play. This backwards game, it's got me all messed up.
I think
up.
We're doing the 4A game. It's hard to tell, you know. But boy, there's been four good games, and we're going to have another penalty walk off here. I believe Immaculate Conception jumped off.
Yep.
Defense.
So a 5-yard penalty on the Knights. Gives DuQuoin first and 5. And the Indians come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got it at the IC 44-yard line. They deploy receivers left and right. And Derek Beard, the carrier for DuQuoin.
Well, I like to watch Immaculate Conception's defense. They get in that base 4-4 they run. They will shift down into a 50 a little bit if DuQuoin goes to two tight ends. But their linebackers are a little bit deeper than normal. They play about 4 or 5 yards, but they really come up at the snap of the football, Jim, and put a hit on people.
A little bit of a loss on the play. So DuQuoin coach Al Martin ponders the second down and 6 call. They toss it right. Beard turns the corner to the 40. Still in his feet. Wrestled down at the 35. It's a first down for the Indians.
Derek Beard, the ball carrier. Be the fifth first down of the evening for DuQuoin. And I am very impressed by their game plan right now. We talked about mixing it up, and they are doing an excellent job of mixing up run and pass. We're going to get a chance to see this replay. Here's Nick Hill. Just a simple toss on the outside. Good block there by number 31, wasn't that?
Cole Endress,
exactly.
Out of his fullback position. First and 10 for the Indians. Back to the action. It's a big run up the middle. On the carry for DuQuoin. Reed Bastion, he's going to score a touchdown. It's a run of 35 yards for Reed Bastion, and DuQuoin has put 2 touchdowns on the board here in the first quarter, and they lead by the score of 13-0.
Boy, this was a play that they set up from the beginning of this football game. Just a little reverse pivot by the quarterback, scissor action, and Bastion goes in untouched. One thing that'll happen with that line, defense for Immaculate, they floated the ball very hard. You've got to do misdirection against it, and they did right there and scored a touchdown.
Derek Beard for the conversion kick, trying to make it 14-0. And you see the kick is good. 3:23 left to play in the opening quarter, and DuQuoin has struck twice in 2 possessions here in the first quarter.
Okay, here's your replay right here. You see the reverse pivot by Hill. And then Bastion just up the middle of the field, everything wide open, good blocks downfield by the receiver. Bastion goes in untouched. And with 3:23 left, we've got a 14-0 game. DuQuoin.
For Bastion, just his 20th carry of the year. He's in limited duty. Bastion is averaging nearly 10 yards per carry, and you saw why right there, showing some good speed.
Well, he added to that average definitely right there on that long carry, so look for them to come back to him a little bit tonight.
And he's only a junior, 6'3", 186 pounder. So 14-0 DuQuoin. Still 3:23 left to go in the quarter. There's Bob Cozy, first year coach at Immaculate Conception, a 12-1 record, and his team playing in the championship game for the first time ever. On the return for Immaculate Conception, Campbell again. Jack Campbell out to just shy of the 40-yard line. On the return of 7 yards.
Well, Immaculate Conception obviously needs to get something going here. They don't even have a first down coming into the game. There you see this last scoring drive for DuQuoin. Not a long one, 2:18, but a 35-yard run by Bastion.
So now let's see if IC can cut into the lead. Schreiber, the quarterback, gives it to Campbell, the fullback, trying to break tackles, can't do it, right into the heart of that defensive line. And that DuQuoin defensive line is anchored by Matt Beckham at 288 pounds at tackle, and Nathan Marks at 257 pounds. If you asked Coach Al Martin about the keys to their defense, it's those two guys right there that occupy blockers and allow their linebackers to roam free.
Yeah, without a doubt. They got 2 very nice defensive end in Cody Edwards and Jordan Campanella on the outside of those guys. So they've got a very nice front 4.
DuQuoin has the advantage size-wise up front. Delayed handoff around the left side. Penalty flag comes in on the play. Gabe Murphy with the carry for the Knights. Let's check the penalty. We'll hear from referee Gary Henson momentarily.
Boy, that's in the area of holding right there.
And the preliminary indication is holding once again. Holding cost Immaculate Conception on its first drive. It cost him a first down. They had a 3rd and short that went to 3rd and long, and they did not convert.
third penalty of the evening already for IC.
DuQuoin has converted six first downs. DuQuoin yet to get a first down. Let's hear from Gary Henson.
Block in the back, 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
And holding in high school can just be a devastating penalty because it's a spot foul. It's a mark from the spot of the foul, not necessarily the line of scrimmage. And there's a legal block in the back. Any penalty like that, holding a legal block in the back, those sorts of penalties are even more devastating in high school than they're in the professional level. They screen it out. It is Mascrino making the catch along the left sideline. He's got wheels, and he's breaking tackles into DuQuoin territory all the way to the 35-yard line. Correction, it was Dan Howard making the catch for 31 yards for Immaculate Conception.
Boy, very well-designed play. We're getting a chance to see this one. Double screen, really, that IC is going to run. Anthony Schreiber sells it like he's going to throw a screen out here to the right-hand side. Watch his footwork. Looking all the way to his right, pops back around. Quick screen, little zip screen out there to the wide out. Three guys out in front of it. Big play for IC.
First down of the game for Immaculate Conception. Schreiber in trouble, looking to run. He's going to be dropped around the line of scrimmage.
That's what DuQuoin wanted to do every time Schreiber takes off and runs a football. They want to make him pay for it. DuQuoin has a nice set of linebackers themselves in Chad Wilson, Cole Endress, and Chase Porter. Not real big, 5'11", 6'1", and 5'10", but they all run very well and have a lot of speed to match IC speed.
Second down and 10 upcoming. Schreiber did good just to get back to the line of scrimmage on that last play. Two receivers go left to the top of your screen, Riccio and Joe Mascrino. Gabe Murphy out of the tailback position with the carry. Moves forward to around the 32 or 33-yard line. They approach the one-minute mark of the opening quarter, and an opening quarter dominated so far by DuQuoin. The Indians on top 14-0. But the Knights showing some signs of life on this drive. They've driven to the DuQuoin 32, and they face a third down call, third and seven. Immaculate Conception so far on third down is 0-for-1. They go with a couple of receivers to the top of your screen. Schreiber looks that direction on the roll. He's gonna tuck it and run. Schreiber dives forward inside the 30 for the 27. He's gonna be about 2 or 3 yards short of the first down. So probably a fourth down that Immaculate Conception coach Bob Cozy will go for.
Exactly, too long to kick a field goal. Looks like they do have a little wind at their back right now, but it's really too long. I would imagine they'll have to go for it here.
Now, Schreiber has kicked a 41-yard field goal this season, and this would be in the neighborhood of 45 yards if he decided to do it. But the wind is out of his back. Earlier today, the wind was out of the south. Now it's shifted to the north.
That's right. Welcome to Central Illinois.
And that is going to do it for the first quarter here at Memorial Stadium. It's 14-0 in favor of DuQuoin in the 3A title game. We'll be back to Memorial Stadium after this local timeout.
All right, we're back at Memorial Stadium, the championship game in Class 3A. DuQuoin leading, Immaculate Conception 14-0. Great story. A lot of people watching tonight via satellite in nearby Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Bill Gross, he's a DuQuoin native. He played for DuQuoin, and his uncle, John Gross, is an assistant coach on the DuQuoin team. And I'll tell you what, DuQuoin fans here tonight want to tell a message to Bill Gross in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and his 20 relatives watching, and that is, now that DuQuoin has the wind in the second quarter, Al Barton's going to throw the ball some, so be ready, guys. They're not going to get conservative here in the second quarter, even though they have a 14-point lead. Jim, Steve?
For the first down on fourth down, and it depends on the spot.
This one's going to be very, very close. Schreiber stuck his arm out, reached the ball. A very dangerous play. I think we're obviously going to have a measurement on this one. Here's the replay. Simple rollout by Schreiber. He's trying to throw the wheel route on the outside here, out and up. Schreiber sees that he has to get back upfield, and I'm not sure he got it right there. Man, but they gave it to him.
So the second first down of this drive for Immaculate Conception. They have it at the DuQuoin 24-yard line. There you see Anthony Schreiber ducking under center. It's a delayed handoff. They give it to Joe Mastrino. First time he has touched the ball today. He's a multi-threat player. Mastrino has caught 20 passes for 340 yards, and he's rushed the ball 109 times for 702 yards, and he's scored a total of 16 touchdowns.
Exactly, 10 of them on the ground. He's a nice running back, not real big, as all are the running backs for IC, but as we keep talking about, it's the speed that all of them possess.
Good. Immaculate Conception, certainly a team that can come back from 14-0 down. They have the offensive weapons to make that happen. Second and nine. And Mastrino, he's got running room. He slips and falls as he started to make a comeback, a cutback around the 13-yard line, but still, it should be good enough for first down yardage.
Boy, nice offensive series here by Immaculate Conception. We're going to see this one more time. Watch the offensive line surge off the football. Now we'll come back to a replay in a minute on that one, maybe.
It is a first down for the Knights as they move up to the line of scrimmage. Dan Clancy is the receiver to the bottom of your screen. Tim Mastrino, the younger brother, goes to the far side of the field. And on a give, Jack Campbell, the fullback up the middle, gets a couple of yards.
Well, it's a huge hit by Cole Endress, number 31. Man, he likes to stick his nose in there a little bit. Coming in as one of their leading tacklers, has 77 tackles on the season. He's quite a football player.
Also plays fullback for the Indians. There you see him there, getting ready for this second down and eight play. Impressive drive here for Immaculate Conception. They've converted three first downs. This drive started back at their own 39-yard line. Now they have it at the DuQuoin 11. Play action, Schreiber, screen pass. It's caught to the five, out of bounds. Close to a first down for Jack Campbell. It's going to be just short of the first down if the spot here on the near side is accurate.
Well, I like that play right there, a little misdirection, play action move. Jack Campbell actually locked on to Jordan Campanella, the defensive end, number 80 for DuQuoin. Looked like he was blocking, then slid off of him, and Schreiber was able to dump it to him. Nice pickup there on second down.
So third down upcoming. Immaculate Conception 0 for 2 on third down so far. Schreiber, there you see him duck under center. A give to the fullback. Up the middle, should be enough for a first down for the Knights. Campbell was again the ball carrier, and it's going to give Immaculate Conception a first and goal deep inside of DuQuoin territory. Now remember, in victories for DuQuoin over Chester, Marshall, Anna Jonesboro, and Monticello in the playoffs, this DuQuoin starting defense has only allowed one touchdown, and Immaculate Conception just about ready to get on the board. Schreiber pitches near side. Mastrino hit in the backfield, wrestled down on the play by Terrence Spiller.
Yeah, Terrence Spiller came up very hard, but he got a lot of help from Jordan Campanella, the defensive end. We can't talk enough about their defensive end. They're really keeping everything inside of them. Campanella got a lot of penetration, allowed the defensive back to come up and make the play.
Campanella is only a junior. He was all Southern Illinois last year for DuQuoin as a sophomore. He's a 6'2", 209-pounder. You can imagine how big that young man is going to be when he comes back for a senior year.
Exactly.
Second down goal to go for the Knights from their own, from the DuQuoin 3-yard line. Schreiber, give up the middle, and it is close, and it's in for the touchdown. On the carry, Kevin Mulligan. It's a 3-yard run and Immaculate Conception on the board, trailing 14-6.
It almost looked like Anthony Schreiber, the quarterback right there, read that one. A little dive option, saw that his fullback was wide open. They're flying outside to pick up quarterback and running back, hands the football off. Good surge by the O-line. They pick up the TD.
What a confidence builder for Immaculate Conception. They fall down 14-0. Now they're on the board. And Schreiber, who's 35 for 37 on conversion kicks, will try to make it a one-touchdown game, and he does. The extra point is good. 14-7 in favor of DuQuoin. DuQuoin with the lead as we go to a network timeout. Immaculate Conception will put it back in play. After a 13-play, an impressive 13-play, 61-yard scoring drive, and they ate up 6.5 minutes of the clock.
Yeah, that was the most important thing. They needed to get something going. Even if they didn't get in the end zone right there, at least get some offensive continuity going. They finally were able to get that back as Schreiber will have to go put the ball back on the tee as the wind is picking up a little bit and blew it off the tee for him.
Well, you know, given my meteorology background, I'd say that a cold front has passed through, and now we've got that north wind blowing, and it's still a pretty consistent wind. Schreiber with a squib kick, and it's going to be covered up at about the 34-yard line by Matt Darnell for DuQuoin. So the Indians, with a 14-7 lead, will go to work. Total yards so far, 134 for DuQuoin and 81 for Immaculate Conception.
Right now, average play per play, DuQuoin's averaging 9.6 yards per play. That's pretty good average.
Yeah, DuQuoin has had the ball twice, and they've scored on both of those possessions. 8:51 to go in the first half. There you see the score on your screen. Up the middle, Endres, the fullback, dives across the 40 to about the 41. Second and four upcoming, around a 6-yard pickup. There you see Cole Endres, the senior fullback, 6'1", 210-pounder, averaging just about 5 yards per carry, and he scored 10 touchdowns this season for the Indians.
I really like that offensive line for DuQuoin. They've got a bunch of hosses up there. Zach Calvert, Chris Ridgeway, Matt Darnell, Cody Edwards, complemented by their tight end, Jordan Campanella. They really get after it.
Again, it's the fullback Endres up the middle. Endres is going to be stopped short of the first down, pushed back by the interior line of Immaculate Conception. It'll bring up a third down and short call for DuQuoin coach Al Martin. Right now, for a report from the sideline, let's go back to Mike Clef.
Hey, Jim and Steve, I was talking to one of the sideline members of Immaculate Conception, and I said, is there anything that Anthony Schreiber does not do? And they said, yeah, he doesn't sell popcorn for us. But in all seriousness, I said, how far can he kick a field goal? And they said, 45 yards, and if he's got tonight's wind, even longer. So keep that in mind should this game be close, and I get the feeling this is going to be a close one.
And the carry goes to the tailback for DuQuoin, stopped right at the first down marker. It was Robbie Tilley on the carry, and they're going to say Tilley has first down yardage. Needed to get 2, and I think he got 2.5.
Yes, he did, barely.
So
good look at Al Martin right there on the sideline. He will call all the offensive plays, and looking over that playlist right there, signaling into Nick Hill.
So far, DuQuoin has outrushed Immaculate Conception, 107-43. Beard sweeping the left side. Derek Beard with the carry.
Derek Beard, the ball carrier.
Couple of yards on the play.
Kevin Mulligan.
DuQuoin, Coach Al Martin in his 15th year. His first year, way back in 1988, he led the Indians to a state championship, and ironically, he is coaching against a guy, Bob Cozy, in his first year taking his team to the title game.
That's pretty impressive just getting there, but Al Martin, in his first coaching year, was able to win that. That's very impressive, and as you mentioned a couple times tonight, he's been back here a few times since then.
Al Martin led DuQuoin to the championship in 1992 as well. He brought the Indians to the title game in 1994 and 1995, where they finished runner-up in those 2 years.
Lost to Bloomington Central Catholic in 94 and Spring Valley Hall in 95.
Hill looking to throw, throwing deep. The ball is off the mark and incomplete. It's going to be a third down coming up. Spiller once again, the intended receiver for the Indians.
That time Terrence Spiller was double covered down the field. I think they've got a quick look at how he can run. They put a little double coverage on him and seems to help out right now.
So third down and long here for the Indians. DuQuoin with the wind at its back now. As we said, from the start of the game, the wind has shifted from predominantly out of the south to out of the north. So DuQuoin has the wind here in the second quarter with 6:48 to go. Third and 8, ball at their own 49. Straight eye formation backfield. Delayed handoff. They go to Beard. Hit hard at the line of scrimmage. He's not going to get the first down. Nowhere close to the first down. And DuQuoin faced with its first punting situation of the evening.
Yeah, that was a good line surge, defensive line surge right there by Patrick Gibbons, Bill Kreft, Bill Bianchi, the big guy in middle. We're going to replay. Watch the defensive line surge here, staying low, knocking people back. They tried to run a little counter gap there. That ball almost came loose too, Jim.
So fourth down and DuQuoin up to the line of scrimmage. Initially like they were going to go for it. Now they drop back in punt formation and Derek Beard will boot it away. Oh, the kick is shanked. It's going to take a little bit of a DuQuoin bounce across the 35 to the 33-yard line. Not a great effort from Beard. Just a 20-yard kick, no return.
Boy, that one could have been blocked as well. The up back right there was able to get a piece of the defender, keep that one from getting blocked. If not, Immaculate Conception is in a business again.
We are exactly halfway through the second quarter here at Memorial Stadium in Champaign. The fourth and final game of the first night of championship weekend here on the IHSA television network. Alito, South Beloit, and Driscoll have already captured championships so far today. Out of the shotgun, four receivers, and a little shovel pass is made to 44. Is that Murphy? Yes, it
yes,
was.
It is.
Murphy with the reception on the shuttle pass and pretty good yardage for Gabe Murphy.
Just another formation that IC will go to make you have to defend the whole field. They'll put Shriver back in shotgun, and we're going to see a replay again. They'll run a little counter gap out of this as well. They'll hand that ball off to the tailback, or Shriver will actually take it on a quarterback draw. This time he actually pitches it, and Gabe Murphy is able to pick up some nice yards.
They stay with the shotgun on second and two. They fake the inside handoff. Now Shriver is going to run. Hey, he's got the corner and he's got wheels. Shriver down the right sideline, pushed out of bounds, but not before a significant gain and a first down for the Knights. It's a pickup of 24 yards for Anthony Shriver.
Yeah, there's the speed we're talking about. We're going to get a look at that one again. Mark Riccio, receiver number five, gave Shriver a great block on the outside.
So the first down run for the quarterback, Shriver. And now, Immaculate Conception in business.
Don't you feel the tempo picking up a little bit for IC? I felt like it was just in DuQuoin playing at their level. You know, they wanted to slow things down a little bit. You just feel the tempo picking up a little bit in IC's favor.
DuQuoin owned the first quarter, and Immaculate Conception owning the second quarter so far. They stay with a shotgun. They fake the inside handoff. Shriver looking to run again towards the near sideline, and he's going to be escorted out of bounds and close to a late hit. Now it's going to be called. They're going to call Campanella for a late hit. It was a late flag.
That's the one that the IC coaches probably talked him into. You can't get away with that on the opposing team's field. We're going to get a replay of this. This is the play we're talking about, trying to run a little quarterback trap right here, quarterback sweep. Shriver can't get outside. Good pursuit by DuQuoin. You know, this is a mistake. You just got to let him go. Don't drive him to the... Anytime you do that to a quarterback especially, they're going to call it every time.
It was already a great play. Endress and Campanella showing their speed on the play to be able to continue to escort Shriver to the sidelines, but the extracurriculars are going to cost DuQuoin 15 yards, and it will be a first down for IC.
Well, you could tell the official wanted to call the flag, but he was making his way through the coaching staff and the other players. It just took him a while to get there to throw the flag.
Foul, personal foul, late hit, White, 15 yards, second down.
So it is not called an automatic first down, and not enough yardage to pick up the first down. That's a slight rule variation, again, in high school as compared to the NFL. A personal foul in the NFL is an automatic first down.
Yes, sir.
So it's going to be second down and four for Immaculate Conception with 5:09 to play in the first half. Out of the shotgun, Shriver rolling right. The lefty throws on the run. It's incomplete. Intended for a Dan Howard, who had a big reception earlier in the ball game of 31 yards.
That's a tough throw for a quarterback, especially a lefty quarterback rolling to his right to try and throw a pinpoint pass like that. Shriver just threw it a little bit out in front of the receiver. Good look at that big offensive line that is in front of Anthony Shriver.
So a third down and three on the scoreboard here at Memorial Stadium. Immaculate Conception moving into the wind, trailing 14-7. Shriver on the run, looking for the corner on the right side. He's going to be pushed out of bounds. No penalty flags come in that time. He did not pick up the first down, so a fourth down call is coming up for Knights coach Bob Cozy.
Man, you know who made that play? It was Cole Endress again from his middle linebacker position. He took off just... was spying on Schreiber, and he just took off and made the play, and now he'll be fourth down in about two or three, as IC will probably go for it right here, Jim.
Certainly four down territory. They have the ball at the 28-yard line.
Well, Schreiber's got his hands on his knees a little bit. He's been running from sideline to sideline. I think he's a little bit tired. He's going to either have to throw this one or hand it off. I don't think you're going to see him running it again.
Out of the shotgun on fourth and three from the DuQuoin 28. Big play. And Schreiber rolling to the near side, airs it out, pass is dropped. It was in the hands of Joe Mastrino. He could not hold on, and Immaculate Conception turns it over on downs. DuQuoin will get it, still leading 14-7.
Boy, that's something you don't see very often. Mastrino dropping one that's right in his hands. Good throw right here by Schreiber. Right on the target. You can see Mastrino just look up. Like right before that ball got there, took his eye off it, hit him in the pads, and fell incomplete.
So still 4:53 to go before halftime. And DuQuoin with the wind at its back and a pretty good quarterback in Nick Hill. There you see the 6'4" Hill ducking under center. But they're going to run out of the wishbone here. They give it to Robbie Tilley. Tilley to the 31-yard line. Pickup of a couple on the play.
This is where they go to that ball control offense, put those double tight ends in there, get their big offensive line out in front of them, three backs, do a little misdirection. I think they'd be very happy to go in here 14-7. I know they're going to look to score, but I think they'd be very happy with that score that's on the scoreboard right now.
Again, any team that is a power team like DuQuoin, the idea is once they go into that sort of power running game, they want to lull you to sleep and then beat you with play action.
Try to hit the home run, exactly.
So they'll go back to the I formation. And a receiver split to the far side. Robbie Tilley out across the 35 to the 36 where he's dropped. It's going to bring up third and short here for DuQuoin as we work down to the four-minute mark of the second quarter. Pat Groby making the tackle for Immaculate Conception. Derek Beard, you see him bringing in the play from head coach Al Martin. Martin is a DuQuoin graduate, graduated from DuQuoin back in 1972.
I don't know if you're supposed to say that, but Al Martin may call you on Monday on that one.
Third and three, out of the wishbone, and a Hill looking to throw. Airs it out in the flat, pass is caught by Endress for a first down as he's escorted out of bounds at the 45-yard line. First down for the Indians on the pass play.
Yep, there's your play action that you talk about. They hammer it away in the middle. Then they try and just sneak Nick Hill out. We're going to see that one replayed one more time. Look at those double tight end. You've got a little misdirection as Hill just sneaks out in the flat, and Endress hauls that one in. That's a nice play call.
You see the athleticism from Nick Hill. He's a good ball handler, and that's such a key with this type of offense, to have a quarterback that can fake well, that can move out of the pocket, throw on the run, and Nick Hill is all of that for DuQuoin. Here Hill's going to keep it. Good cutback. Hill to the 50, five-yard run, an impressive five-yard run for Nick Hill.
Yeah, he ran about 30 yards to get there. He was just one block away, it seemed like, the whole time he ran that football. Clock is still moving, 3:17 here in the second quarter.
Right at midfield for the Indians of DuQuoin, playing in the title game for the sixth time. They've won two of their previous five. This is the first time they played in the title game here in Champaign. The first five, of course, were at Hancock Stadium in Normal. Wishbone give to Derek Beard. Beard into IC territory. Short pickup on the play. Third and short upcoming for DuQuoin.
Well, I'd like to see him relocate Terrence Spiller again, the receiver, number seven for DuQuoin. He's been pretty quiet here this second quarter. Was able to score that one touchdown early. I look for them to, as the clock's winding down here in the first half, to go to Spiller a little bit.
Third down and four. And DuQuoin 3-for-4 on third down so far tonight. Play action, Hill rolling left. He stops and throws it deep. The ball tipped away. It was intended for the tight end, Jordan Campanella. And good defensive effort by Immaculate Conception.
You're going to see Campanella here as a tight end, just going to run a real deep post on the replay. You see him right there. He's going to run down the field, break into the middle. Nick Hill throws this ball actually late. He's lucky that one wasn't picked off. Campanella was open early. Nick Hill just threw it a little bit late.
And Dan Howard got a hand on it, and also Mark Riccio was back there for Immaculate Conception. So DuQuoin in a punting situation, it'll be Derek Beard to boot it, and going back deep will be Joe Mastrino in single safety at his own 20-yard line. High snap, but and they're going to fake it. Now, no, actually wasn't a fake. It was actually kicked at the last moment by Beard. And not a bad effort by Derek Beard. That was interesting looking. I think he thought that it was going to get blocked, so he started to run, and he winds up with a 34-yard punt with no return.
No, I definitely thought this one was going to be blocked. Just the same play like ran before. Watch the surge by IC right there. What a great job by Beard. I mean, that one was going to be blocked, and just get it on the ground, kick it off, and make something happen. Now you're going to make IC go about 90 yards to score a touchdown.
Day number two of championship week here at Memorial Stadium coming up tomorrow. The 6A title game commences at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. There you see the schedule. All four of those games right here from the IHSA television network. Some great matchups tomorrow. We certainly had some great matchups today. Mastrino with a carry to the near side. Wow. Hit hard and pushed back. Wow, what a great stick by Chase Porter out of his linebacker position.
I can't talk enough about how their linebackers just flow to the football. And when they get there, they put a lick on you. You're going to see this one again. And this is one you got to protect yourself. There you see linebacker. Watch him come up and make a play. He really stays with it. He's on the ground two different times right there. And number 34, Chase Porter makes a great hit.
Porter, the leading tackler for DuQuoin coming in. Second down and long, and the play up the middle for not much, and it looks like we're going to get a timeout taken by DuQuoin. They want Immaculate Conception to have to punt into the wind here in the latter stages of the second quarter.
Seems like the special teams have been quite eventful, so why not make them punt?
Matt Beckham.
Maybe something can happen.
So during the timeout, we'll keep it here, and 14-7 is the lead for DuQuoin. Let's take a look at some information about the schools participating in this 3A title game. DuQuoin, the pride of Perry County in deep southern Illinois. DuQuoin, about 15 miles straight north of Carbondale on Route 51. They're champions of the Southern Illinois River to River Conference with an enrollment of about 454 students. And Immaculate Conception out of the Chicago suburbs located in Elmhurst. And their actual enrollment, as we fast forward to that here momentarily, just 275 is the actual enrollment for Immaculate Conception. But the teams that Immaculate Conception plays on a regular basis are much bigger. Hence, they're in 3A instead of 1A.
Exactly. We just saw one of them, Driscoll, played. You know, they also play Aurora Central Catholic, Lombard Montine. That's quite a conference. I'll tell you, you see year after year a team in that conference participating in the state championships.
Driscoll has already won, and Immaculate Conception trying to make it two teams from the Suburban Catholic Conference to win state titles. It is going to be third down and 11 as we come out of the timeout. Shriver on a delayed handoff, gives the ball to Murphy, and the ball came loose. The ball came loose, and they're going to say that he was down. Murphy was down. It brings up fourth down, and I'm sure DuQuoin will call another timeout with 1:08 to go, and they do. DuQuoin calls a timeout, and now a punting situation for Immaculate Conception. It'll be interesting to see who is going to punt here for Immaculate Conception. Now, we know that Anthony Shriver, the quarterback, has punted successfully this year for IC, but also we saw earlier in the game Matt Jaswiak, he punted as well.
Exactly. I went to that game Wilmington last week, and Jaswiak was actually the punter and kicker.
Looking at playoff history for these teams, how about DuQuoin? 19 consecutive appearances in the playoffs, trying for their third state title and overall playoff record of a sparkling 48-16.
Right.
And not quite the playoff experience for Immaculate Conception. They're in the postseason party for the first time since 1992. And ironically, all the way back in 1974, the first year of the state playoffs, Immaculate Conception did advance all the way to the Class 3A semifinals. They lost to West Chicago, and West Chicago went on to defeat Mount Carmel in the title game that year.
You know, a good story about that 1974 team. They've been all week last week before they played Wilmington sending this team from Immaculate Conception jerseys, shoes, and all of that to show them how much they care about them continuing their winning ways.
We just saw how strong the wind is right now. That punt straight up into the air, 23 yards against the wind. No return, and DuQuoin with outstanding field position. Now the Indians are out of timeouts. There you see the flags blowing high atop the north end of the stadium here at Memorial Stadium. The wind out of the north now. Earlier today it was very strong, but out of the south. So DuQuoin with great field position, wind at its back from the 41-yard line.
Look for Terrence Spiller. He's up there on the top of the screen all by himself, one-on-one.
Hill looking to throw. He throws it for Spiller. The ball is going to be overthrown and incomplete. Great matchup there. How about that? Anthony Shriver playing defense against Terrence Spiller. Talk about a couple of athletes going one-on-one.
Yeah, they're the two best athletes on this field. IC did give him a little bit of help with Mark Riccio. Came over from his free safety position to help double coverage, but that ball was just overthrown.
So second down upcoming here for the Indians. DuQuoin scored on its first two possessions of the game to go up 14-0 in the first quarter. IC answered with a touchdown here in the second quarter. Hill looking to throw again. Rolling left. Still looking. Now he throws and it's incomplete. Intended for Spiller along the left sideline. It'll bring up a third down call. The clock stopping with 43 ticks left to go in the second quarter.
Jordan Campanella was actually open about the hash mark, but he kept running into Spiller and bringing coverage with him, so nobody was open by the time Hill was ready to throw the football.
So the Indians face with a third and 10 from the Immaculate Conception 41-yard line.
I think you got to take a shot right here at the end zone. Try and get in a one-on-one coverage. We see number 9, Reed Bastion, at the top of the screen. See if they go to him on this one.
Draw play, running room. It is Beard on the carry for DuQuoin. He's not going to get the first down. Had some room to run initially, but then ran out of real estate, and he was pushed back. Fourth down, clock rolling with 25 seconds left to go in the quarter. Now, if DuQuoin doesn't want to, they're not going to have to run another play. The ball was just marked ready for play.
They're going for it.
And they are going to go for it here on fourth down. And Immaculate Conception is going to call the timeout instead.
That's a smart play by Al Martin. Go up and set up, make them call the timeout. It's only going to help you as well. 14 seconds left here, second quarter. Let's see what happens.
Bob Cozy, there is the head coach for Immaculate Conception. He's been with the program as a coach for 8 years. He's also the girls softball coach at Immaculate Conception. He's been in that position for 9 years. He was the head junior varsity coach at IC for 7 years before taking over the program this year. Looking back to the other games that have been played, other state title games played today here at Memorial Stadium, what a great one in Class 2A.
Man.
Aledo rallying from 18 points down in the fourth quarter to nip Carthage 41-40 in overtime. South Beloit pulling away in the second half to defeat El Paso 50-22 in 1A. And how about Driscoll? Very, very impressive rout of Mount Carmel. Mount Carmel undefeated coming in, and Driscoll rolled to a 35-0. Then Mount Carmel rolled to a 35-0 halftime lead and won the game 42-0 over Mount Carmel of Illinois. Of course, Chicago Mount Carmel will play in the 6A title game tomorrow. Fourth down, 14 seconds to go. Rolling left. Hill heaves it down the left sideline. The ball is going to be overthrown and incomplete. Intended for Reed Bastion. And Immaculate Conception will get the ball with 6 seconds to go in the second quarter as DuQuoin turns it over on downs.
Smart play. That's exactly what we talked about. Take a shot in the end zone. You never know what might happen. You could get a penalty as well. Defensive pass interference, something like that. There's Bastion right there. I'll tell you, some of these players are really winded. And he's one of them. As I would imagine, Immaculate Conception would take a knee here, but we've seen all kinds of crazy things today. Maybe they'll throw it down the field as well.
Immaculate Conception will get the ball first to start the second half. You just saw Reed Bastion moments ago. He scored a touchdown on a run earlier in the game for DuQuoin. It looks like Immaculate Conception will take a knee, and Schreiber does step back from the line of scrimmage to kill the clock here in the second quarter. DuQuoin at the half, leading Immaculate Conception by the score of 14-7. DuQuoin scoring its touchdowns in the first quarter on a pass from Hill to Spiller and the 35-yard run by Reed Bastion, and Immaculate Conception answering with a touchdown in the second quarter to make it close and get it at 14-7, get within 14-7 here in the second quarter as we move into halftime. And a great job by IC of gaining composure. Boy, it was a truck rolling for DuQuoin early right in the ballgame. They looked really impressive on their first two drives. Immaculate Conception got the offense in gear. They settled their defense down, and we've got a ballgame here at halftime.
You're right. They're getting ready to get rolled out of this football game. They're getting blown out. They settled down a little bit. You know, as we talked about, they haven't been here very often. They don't really know what to experience, man. DuQuoin has, and they settled down and got it close, 14-7.
And right now here at halftime, let's go down to the field. Mike Kleff is standing by with DuQuoin head coach Al Martin.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. And Al Martin, first of all, you've got to be thrilled with the 7-point lead at halftime. I know you'd take it going in, but yet I know you're going to go in there and tell your kids we're doing some things well, but we got to clean up some things.
Yes, they're a quick team. Their quarterback, he's gotten out of the pocket a couple of times, and we've got to contain him. He's a good athlete. And, we think we got some quickness, but we got to be, you know, just be on top of our game a little bit better. And I think contain him. He can make some plays happen. And I think offensively, we just need to keep trying to be balanced, mix the run and the pass up a little bit better. And, try to score a couple more touchdowns, come on top at the end.
Al, I thought your opening drive going down and getting points, that seemed to do a lot for your players' confidence.
Yes, it did. I thought we moved the ball well, and we blocked well up front, and they've made some adjustments, and now we have to make some adjustments. They're bringing more people up front, and we're going to have to counter a little bit with some other things.
All right, Al, good luck second half.
All right, thank you.
Al Martin, the DuQuoin coach, his team leading right now 14-7, but as we've seen, this game is far from over because we've got a whole lot more football to play in what is an entertaining day of football. We'll be right back after these local messages. All right, we're back at Memorial Stadium. We're at halftime of the Class 3A championship game between Immaculate Conception and DuQuoin. DuQuoin leading right now 14-7. And now it is equal opportunity airtime for the cheerleaders. First of all, the Knights of Immaculate Conception, they're here tonight. All right, let's hear your favorite cheer. Go ahead and cheer away. All right, it's their first state championship game for a lot of the cheerleaders, but they obviously know the Knights of Immaculate Conception, what they're doing. And they've scored the most recent points here in the first half. It's 14-7 at halftime of the 3A championship game. Okay, now, DuQuoin, we're going to hear from their cheerleaders in a moment. Real quick, what is your name?
Raven.
Raven, what do you think of your team's performance so far?
They're awesome. I can't believe we're here right now. It's great.
All right. Raven, good luck second half. Good luck.
Thank you.
Hey, that's all right. Okay, now we're going to move right on over here to the DuQuoin Indian cheerleaders. Their team ahead 14-7 at the half. What is the one cheer that you just love doing more than anything?
Competition cheer.
Yeah. All right, let's hear it. Competition. 's fired up as well. Let me ask you something. What's your name and what year are you in school?
Taylor Whitley, sophomore in high school.
All right, you've got a number 44 and a number 62. Who are they?
Chad Wilson and Daryl Anders.
Okay, why did you pick those numbers?
Because this is my boyfriend and that's my best guy friend.
All right, good decisions. All right, we got a number 80, a 41, and an 84. Now, number 41, how tall is he?
He's kind of short. He's good. Yeah.
He is. All right. And now, number 80 is much taller.
Oh, yes, he is. He's our good guy.
Okay. Now, who gets to randomly assign the numbers here? Does that work that way, Annie?
We just pick them out. Yeah. Our best guy friends.
All right. Yeah. All right. 14-7, DuQuoin leading right now.
Oh, yeah!
We'll have more from Memorial Stadium right after these local messages. We're back at Memorial Stadium, halftime of the Class 3A championship game between DuQuoin and Immaculate Conception. DuQuoin leading 14-7, and we're joined live now by the man in charge of all the football here, Dave Ganaway with the IHSA. And Dave, I've talked to you off camera, but you know, here we are now, back-to-back years. Last year, we have the 4A championship game, goes to double overtime between Mount Carmel and Driscoll Catholic. Today, the 2A championship game, 41-40 overtime. You'd love to have those kind of games every game, wouldn't you?
Oh yeah, that's great football, and you know, that's what they come down here for, is to have a great game and just get into an overtime. What more can you ask for?
How nervous do you get watching these games?
I don't get real nervous now, from about 6 in the morning till about 1, till you get that first game and the whole thing under control, you're a little nervous, but now everybody's doing what they're doing, it gets into a routine and it gets into a real nice flow.
Dave, I'm asking this in all seriousness. The previous game, I think most people here were so surprised in the 4A game that it ended up 42-0, especially the previous year when they played such a thrilling game. And I could see it in your face. You were happy for Driscoll Catholic. At the same time, you feel for teams that come away from this final game with a loss.
Oh, I've been in that position coaching, you know, and you get into a game like that where you know you can get it done, but all of a sudden you can't figure out how to shut the faucet off because everything just keeps running on you, and that's kind of the situation that Mount Carmel got themselves into. But overall, you know, they've had a great year and a great 2 years, and it's so tough to get back here back to back. I mean, it's just tough to do, and they need to be congratulated on that. And Addison Driscoll and having a great year and a great championship game.
And yet we have two great stories in this game. You've got a guy like Immaculate Conception's coach Bob Cozy, first-year guy, went through the ranks, and then you have Al Martin, who I know you've been familiar with for a long time. And Al Martin, you probably couldn't find five words who speak ill of the guy. I mean, he's old school, and I say that in a great way.
Oh, absolutely. You've got two great scenarios here and two great crowds here watching the game. So it's a 14-7 game right now, and I think we might end up seeing one of those maybe overtime games here.
Seriously, how often do you have to fight yourself when you see a great play and you want to see great plays? How often do you fight yourself having to restrain yourself instead of just wanting to jump up and down and cheer?
Oh, I really don't restrain myself. You know, I'm not cheering for any team. I'm just cheering for a great football play. And when you see somebody make a great football play, whether it be offense or defense, all the coaches around the state have coached before, they know that they get excited over seeing a great football play. So, you know, it's just fun to see, and especially fun to see in games like this.
Dave, I know the mind's always spinning. The coach in you has to like the way this is going, the setup here and everything. And yet the coach in you, you're always trying to tweak things and take it to a higher level, aren't you?
Oh, absolutely. And I think, you know, we always look at what can you do better and get feedback from coaches, principals, and see how you can end up running tournaments better. And when coaches leave here, I try and get an idea from the coaches that have been here. What can we do better here at the state finals to make it better next year for the teams that are returning? And their input helps a lot in making this day good for the schools and the kids that are playing.
What did you learn as a coach that you apply to what you do here now?
Oh, I think the work ethic that you learn coming through there really is a big difference. And you know that you got to pay attention to every detail, and every little detail of running a tournament like this or any state tournament, you don't want to leave unturned. So the details have really stuck with me from my coaching days.
All right, Dave, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
All right. Dave Ganaway, he's the guy in charge of football for the IHSA. And I think it's working. I think it's working really well, because not only have we had good football today, but we have good football tomorrow starting at 10 a.m. The 6A title game between Chicago Mount Carmel, that powerful caravan program, and the Bloomington Purple Raiders out of the Big 12. And for more on the Purple Raiders and a very stout defense, here's Kurt Pegler.
When opponents scout Bloomington, the first thing they usually focus on stopping is a high-flying offense led by quarterback Andre Brown. But even with that high-powered offense scoring points left and right, Bloomington feels the key to its success in the playoffs this year has been the
defense. You know, the old cliche says defense wins championships, and our kids have shown great tenacity. They're not the biggest guys out there, but they fly around. There's good speed. They understand the schemes. I think they're well-prepared for the team that they're playing against.
That defense shut out Thornton Fractional South in the second half on Saturday, holding Illinois recruit Pierre Thomas to 103 yards rushing, his lowest total of the season.
It feels good when you don't, when they don't even score any points, because it's like you just dominated the whole game and they couldn't do nothing about it.
The Purple Raiders haven't surrendered a point in the third quarter all year long and are allowing only 5.7 points a game. Not bad for a unit that nobody seems to know anything about.
The defense doesn't get much press, and that even don't see much paper time or anything like that, but they still do their job, and we just keep the offense in it. We try to score points if we can.
The Raiders defense says it doesn't mind playing second fiddle to the offense, just so long as Bloomington finishes first at state.
All right, it's the second half, just around the corner of the 3A championship game between DuQuoin and Immaculate Conception. DuQuoin leading 14-7. We're just moments away from the second half kickoff. We'll be back right after these local messages.
Back in the booth at Memorial Stadium in Champaign, Jim Spencer and Steve Mays, 14-7. There you see the score, DuQuoin leading Immaculate Conception here in the Class 3A state title game. Let's take a look at the halftime statistics. And all in all, the rush yardage is what really jumps out there at you, Steve, in favor of DuQuoin.
Well, exactly right. And you look at that, you know, those first downs, only eight of them. But I tell you, they have really been able to run the ball. I'm surprised that they've only thrown for 47. You know, they don't throw it a whole lot. But I think the thing that's really nice to see in this whole picture is the turnovers.
None
for either team. That's very nice. Time of possession is very close. Penalty yards. That doesn't really matter right there. Pretty clean played game here so far in the first half.
In terms of a third down efficiency, Immaculate Conception struggling a little bit, but DuQuoin very efficient in the first half.
They have been, and I'm very impressed with their game plan. And as Al Martin mentioned there in his halftime interview, they just need to stay with what they're doing, mixing it up a little bit.
Right now, down to the field we go, where Mike Kleff is standing by with IC coach Bob Cozy.
All right, thanks, guys. Coach Cozy, what did you tell your team at halftime?
Well, we got to play a lot better football than what we've been playing. First quarter, we looked like a team that never been in a state championship before. We got to play a lot better this half. I think you'll see a better half. We're being outmanned at the line of scrimmage, and if we don't do anything about that, it's going to be a long night.
It sounds like you challenged your kids.
I certainly did challenge them. And every year, every game this week, they've come back to answer the challenge, and I expect they're going to do it in the second half.
All right, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
All right. Bob Cozy, you can tell he's fired up. He's hoping his players are as well. Jim, Steve.
Let's take a look at some of the first half highlights. DuQuoin scoring first, folks. This was a fourth down play on DuQuoin's first drive.
Yeah, this is the pass to Terrence Spiller. Made that inside move and got to the outside, and you see the nice arm by Nick Hill. Put it right on the mark.
And on this play, DuQuoin fooling Immaculate Conception. Reed Bastion, who hasn't carried the ball very much, goes 35 yards for the score.
Yeah, they set that play up very well in the first quarter, running that same motion. Then they just hand it back to Bastion. He gets in untouched for the touchdown.
And then Immaculate Conception getting on the board here. Their touchdown coming in the second quarter, Kevin Mulligan with the run.
Yeah, he's one of the three or four running backs that you will see I see use. Mulligan, very hard runner. They like to give him the football when it's short and third and short, second short.
Yeah, his only carry of the game went for that three-yard touchdown for Immaculate Conception to get them on the board after falling down 14-0. DuQuoin in the first half with 172 yards of total offense. 138 of those 172 yards came on their first two drives where they scored touchdowns. The IC defense stepped up after those first two drives.
They did, as well as the offense. You know, we talked about that 6 minute and 18 second drive that IC finally had after having to punt it the first couple times. I thought the offense stepped up as well.
Individual numbers in the first half. DuQuoin is led rushing-wise by Robbie Tilley. He's got 8 carries for 42 yards. Passing-wise for DuQuoin, Nick Hill, 3 out of 8 for 47 yards in that touchdown that we saw in the highlights earlier. And Anthony Schreiber, 3 of 6 passing for Immaculate Conception for 45 yards. Schreiber also the leading rusher for IC with 29 yards on 9 carries. At the half here at Memorial Stadium in Champaign, DuQuoin on top of Immaculate Conception in the 3A title game. We'll be back for the second half after this local timeout. The third quarter will commence momentarily. There you see the DuQuoin Indians rallying around their coach, Al Martin, as they get ready for the second half. DuQuoin will go on defense to start the third quarter. So Immaculate Conception will have the wind with an opportunity to possibly pull even with DuQuoin on their first drive of the second half.
I would imagine here going into the win, DuQuoin will be very happy with running the football, going back to their running backs and handing the ball off. I can't imagine they're going to throw a whole lot. They're getting handed off to Cole Endres, Robbie Tilley, maybe throw a little bit on the outside to Terrence Spiller, but I would imagine they're going to run the football here in the third quarter.
And now on the other side of things, obviously IC with a chance to go to the air with what has become a pretty strong wind at their back here in the quarter. In the third quarter, Derek Beard, there you see him teeing it up for DuQuoin. Riccio and Mastrino are the deep men for Immaculate Conception. Around the 25-yard line, they're expecting a squib kick. That is what DuQuoin has done all night. The second half is ready to get going. Again, the expected squib kick. Riccio at the 30. Cuts back, fumbles the football, ball on the turf, and Immaculate Conception is back on top of it. And recovering it was Mark Felici.
Yeah,
Felici. There you see number 20 recovering that fumble, and that is a fortunate break for Immaculate Conception to keep the ball.
Well, that's not the way you want to start out the second half, especially when they're kicking it off to you. Turn it over right away, give them great field position. Let's see here if Immaculate Conception cranks it up a little bit. They went to that shotgun there late in the second quarter. Let's see if they come out and run a little bit of that here in the third quarter.
They show I to start off, and they're going to give it to Campbell, the fullback. Breaks a tackle at the line. He fumbles the ball. Ball loose on the turf, and they scramble for it, and it looks like Immaculate Conception is back on top of it as the officials put the 2 up in the air to indicate second down. That's 2 plays in a row that Immaculate Conception has coughed it up. Here's a replay.
Yeah, I think Victor Corral will get on this one eventually, but Jack Campbell had a nice little seam there. Just see the ball out loose, and I can't see who that was. It might have been Endres with the hat on the football, or Chase Porter, I think it was, and Immaculate Conception very lucky to get that football back.
So second down and 8. Schreiber under center. Looking to throw. The lefty steps up. Kennedy throws. And a scramble for the ball. Is it a pass? They're going to say incomplete. Incomplete pass. Third down coming up for Immaculate Conception. Boy, things are rather precarious for the Knights right now.
They really are. What a great effort by Nathan Marks right there, the defensive tackle number 64. He's 6'3", 257. He almost made that interception right there off of the Anthony Schreiber deflected pass.
Schreiber has the ability to throw, certainly. He's thrown for over 1,200 yards this year. Last week in the semifinal over undefeated Wilmington, a 26-15 IC victory. He was 9 of 15 for 238 and 3 touchdowns. So far tonight, he's only 3 of 7 for 45 yards, the co-player of the year in the Suburban Catholic Conference. Penalty flags on the play, and it's going to be delay of game on Immaculate Conception. The play clock runs out. It'll cost him 5 yards to make it 3rd and 12.
Yeah, I'm not sure exactly.
Dead ball foul. Delay of game. Offense.
I don't think Schreiber liked the play that was called. He was trying to change it maybe at the line of scrimmage. Took a little bit long and got called for the penalty.
So now Immaculate Conception faced with a 3rd and 12. Schreiber faking the end around, screens it out to the near side to Murphy. Murphy has running room to the 40, 50, first down and more. Murphy into DuQuoin territory, all the way to the 30-yard line. A big play for Gabe Murphy of 38 yards on 3rd and 12.
Well, we saw that play ran earlier in the first half. The screen one way and go back the other way. We will get a chance to see this. I like it when they run a screen with Murphy. He's got some nice speed. Not a big guy. You see the play action, fake the reverse, and then Schreiber just passes it out flat, and Murphy's wide open. Good blocks downfield by the offensive line. Does a good job staying in bounds, lowering that shoulder, picking up extra yards.
Schreiber did a good job of throwing the ball to Murphy in a position where he could continue his momentum and make positive yardage on the play. They toss it left to Joe Mastrino, tiptoeing, looking for running room, and he's dropped around the line of scrimmage. Short pickup on the play for Joe Mastrino to bring up 2nd and long. Just into the third quarter, Class 3A state championship game at Memorial Stadium in Champaign. 14-7 is the lead for DuQuoin. There you see Mr. Mastrino, a 5'10", 155-pound senior. And Coach Bob Cozy says he's 155 pounds, totally dressed and absolutely wet. The 155 pounds is a little generous.
Well, that's how it's supposed to be in high school. I think everybody does a little bit of that.
Murphy with the carry to around the 25-yard line. So a 3rd down call coming up. And this would be considered field goal range for Anthony Schreiber with the wind at his back. And you're looking at around a 42-yard attempt. So if Immaculate Conception doesn't convert here on 3rd down, they might think about the field goal.
See the last replay right here as Gabe Murphy hits up in the inside. Nice little seam right there as the offensive line. Victor Corral, number 74 in the center. David Suarez, nice job sealing off the inside.
And it's a give on a dive play to the fullback up the middle. It's not going to net first down yardage. Cole Endress and Chase Porter there to drop Jack Campbell. And 4th down upcoming, and let's see what Immaculate Conception will do. Down a 14-7.
Yeah, I would think they're going to go for it here. I know Schreiber has the leg to get it there, but this is really 4 down territory for them.
It's going to be 4th down and 2. 4th and 2. IC is 1 for 2 on 4th down tonight. Schreiber under center, rolling far side, looking to throw, airs it out, passes incomplete. It was intended for Dan Howard, and once again, IC turns it over on downs. Great drive, but it stalls out, and DuQuoin takes over, now working against the wind.
You know what? I think they've really got their offense cranked up there, as you see Howard right there. That ball should have been caught. And now DuQuoin will have the football here about the 22-yard line. We are going to get a chance to see that last play. It's a good throw by Schreiber. Rolling out. This is what he does best right here. The ball's right on the money. That one should be caught.
So DuQuoin takes over at their own 22-yard line. Nick Hill, the quarterback, gives it up the middle to the fullback, Endress. Short pickup on the play. And DuQuoin has had trouble getting on track offensively outside of those first two drives where they scored their only 2 touchdowns.
That's right. I'll tell you, I'm pretty impressed with the defensive lineman for Immaculate Conception. A little bit undersized. They've moved David Suarez, who's the center on offense, in at nose guard, and he's giving DuQuoin a little bit of a fit.
Option, Hill, keeper across the 25 to the 29. 3rd down and about 4 will be upcoming for DuQuoin. There you see Nick Hill. A little bit of a family lineage here. Nick Hill playing in the championship game. After 3 of his cousins also played in championship games for DuQuoin. Trent played in 1986, Aaron played in 1988, and Adam played in 1992. So it's a Hill family tradition playing for DuQuoin here in the state title game. It is 3rd down and 4. Out of the eye, Hill back to pass, airs it out near side incomplete. It was intended for Ricky Oakley. There you see Oakley number 10. 4th down and against the wind, DuQuoin will be forced to punt good defense to stand as IC forces a DuQuoin three and out.
Yeah, IC should get very good field position right here as Anthony Schreiber will go back and field this punt. All right, take that back. That might be Joe Mastrino, number two, and not number seven.
So DuQuoin will have Derek Beard to punt it. And twin safety for Immaculate Conception. The kick into the wind is away, and a pretty good one at that. It's going to sail out of bounds on the near sidelines, and they're going to mark it at the 40-yard line. Actually, the 39, now the 40. The official couldn't decide.
Gave him an extra yard right there.
They mark it at the 40. It is against the wind, a 31-yard punt, no return.
I think Al Martin will take that after what's happened the last couple times.
And right now, with 7:22 to play third quarter, Mike Kleff has a report for us down on the field.
Steve, hey, we hear about a DuQuoin alum watching via satellite in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. We have a couple of more DuQuoin alums watching via satellite from Orlando, Florida. Charles and Connie Shryock. And they're both rooting hard for the Indians, and you can bet they're loving life in Orlando right now, the 14-7 lead. Jim, Steve?
All right, they're watching us all over.
All over the country.
And on that last play, it was a little shuttle pass to Murphy, and a short pickup on the play. There you see middle linebacker Cole Endress a few moments ago for DuQuoin. Second and nine upcoming as the Knights charge up to the line of scrimmage. They'll go with four receivers, trips to the bottom of the screen, and a shotgun. They had success with this formation in the second quarter.
Right, I thought they'd go back to a little bit sooner than they have right here.
Schreiber airs it out over the head of Dan Howard's incomplete. A little bit too much mustard on that pass, and it's going to be third and long for Immaculate Conception. The defense has certainly have taken over in this game.
Yeah, that pass right there, you saw the strength of Anthony Schreiber's arm. He really has a cannon.
So a third down here for the Knights. They're 2 for 7 on third down so far tonight. This is a third and long, third and nine. They had pretty good field position after the punt at their own 40. Now they have it at their own 41. You see 6:40 left to play, third quarter. IC down by a touchdown. And they'll go with four receivers, two each direction. Out of the shotgun, Schreiber over the middle. Pass is going to be incomplete. Incomplete. Pass was intended for 33, Tim Mastrino, the younger brother of Joe. And it's fourth down, and IC will be forced to punt.
Yeah, you're going to see Mastrino here in the replay. Run just a deep post route. And this ball's just underthrown right here by Schreiber. And no way the receiver can catch one when it's thrown in the ground, as IC will now be forced to punt here with 6:35 left to go in the third quarter.
High snap, Schreiber kicking it this time. He manages to get it away with the wind at his back. It's going to bounce and take a good IC roll inside the 20 all the way down to the 14-yard line. And Schreiber was his athleticism just allowed him to get that kick away. And then it ends up paying positive dividends. A 46-yard punt, no return for Anthony Schreiber.
Yeah, he'll take that. Even though it rolled 20 yards, he will take that. As once again, here going into the wind, DuQuoin will be forced to start with their back against their own end zone.
You got to be careful here. You don't want a turnover deep inside of your own territory. And DuQuoin has been very stingy. They've only turned the ball over 12 times through the first 13 games of the year. And neither team has turned it over so far tonight.
No, that's really incredible.
Give up the middle out to the 15-yard line. That was Robbie Tilley, the leading ball carrier for DuQuoin so far tonight. That was his ninth carry. He now has 44 yards on the ground.
That's a good hit right there by one of the linebackers for IC, Kevin Mulligan, 6'190" and a junior. Comes in with 120 tackles, 6 sacks, 78 of those tackles are solos. So he's got a nose for that football from his linebacker position.
Second and 8 for DuQuoin. Ball just across the 15-yard line. They toss it to Tilley. Hit at the line of scrimmage, and he manages to surge forward, get a little bit of positive yardage there. And third and long against the wind upcoming for the Indians. I see Tilley going back into the huddle. Tilley, a 5'10", 177-pound senior. Tilly will graduate, but we saw probably a pretty good tailback for IC next year, Reed Bastion, with his run earlier in the game. You'd think that as a junior, he'd fit in and replace Tilly next year for DuQuoin. Third down, what will the Indians do? It's Bastion again with good yardage. Reed Bastion with the carry, close to the first down marker, maybe a little bit short. He needed to get six. Let's check the spot here.
Yeah, he's going to be about a yard and a half short. He'll be forced to punt it one more time.
DuQuoin will be forced to punt into the wind. And once again, Immaculate Conception should get good field position. Let's see if they can take advantage. IC has had the wind here in the third quarter. There's only 4:40 left to go. And the Knights really haven't taken advantage of that wind here in this quarter.
Exactly right. I go back to what we talked about at the beginning of the show, the keys to the game. And for Immaculate Conception, we said they had to stop the run. Did a pretty nice job here in the third quarter.
Line drive kick from Derek Beard. It's going to hit and take a little bit of a DuQuoin inside of IC territory to the 49-yard line. 30-yard punt against the wind, no return. And Immaculate Conception will take over. First and 10 in great field position.
Yeah, they have had nice field position here in the second half. I'd like to see them go to that shotgun a little bit more. They had so much success with it there in the second quarter. I thought they'd really come out and run it all third quarter. We saw it a little bit there at the last series. Let's see if they go back to it.
Schreiber is 5 out of 12 passing for 84 yards. They go with a straight eye and receivers left and right. Schreiber, play action. Looking to throw. Lots of time. Now he's going to tuck it around. Schreiber gets a couple of yards on the play on the scramble. Jordan Campanella, out of his defensive end position, able to make that play.
Able to track him down is right. I'll tell you, Schreiber had Dan Clancy running down the middle of the field and just missed him.
Before this second down play, we go back down to the field and Mike Pleff.
Jim, Steve, we've seen enough games when sidelines become more and more confident. And that's exactly what's happening with Immaculate Conception, because I'll tell you what, you guys see it, we see it. Since DuQuoin scored twice early in this game, the Knights defense has really clamped down and they're playing with a lot of confidence. Now they're trying to drive the tying score. Jim, Steve.
Second and 7 for the Knights. Murphy with the carry to the 45. Maybe he got to the 44. It's gonna bring up a third down and manageable for Immaculate Conception.
Boy, if you ask me, both defenses are being real stingy here in this third quarter. I'll tell you, it's great defensive line and linebacker play right now going on by both teams.
Third down and 2. We approach the 3-minute mark of the quarter and we've got an official timeout before this 3rd and 2 play. I think you're pretty close to 4-down territory, aren't you here, Steve, if IC doesn't convert here on third down? Immaculate Conception just 2 of 8 on third down. Schreiber on a delayed rollout, looking near side, top flies the pass. A pickup of 16 and a first down. Correction, it was number 80 and not number 30. It was Larry Zaranti making the reception for IC.
Boy, watch how Schreiber sells this play from the replay right there. You see him rolling out. Tough play for a lefty QB. I thought he overthrew it right there, but Zarante brings that ball in. Look at him diving for that extra effort. And that has really fired the crowd up for Immaculate Conception. Finally, we hear him in this football game.
First down for IC. Looking for the tying or go-ahead score. Mastrino up the middle. He's got running room. Cuts back to the 15. He's brought down by Beard. Another first down on the pickup of 12 yards.
Boy, the touchdown saving tackle by Beard right there. It was one-on-one. Watch the offensive line surge. You're just going to see everything part. And you're going to see Beard come in here and save this play. This is a touchdown if he doesn't make that tackle.
At the 15. IC on the march, 2:10 to play, third quarter. Mastrino again with a carry, hit at the 15 and falls forward to the 14-yard line.
Andrus, always down at the bottom of the pile. You see number 31, first one to get up right there from his middle linebacker position. Really can run sideline to sideline.
There you see Cole Andrus, the middle linebacker and fullback for the Indians. There's a lot of people who could be leaders on the defense, but Cole Andrus is pretty close to being the heart and soul of the DuQuoin defense out of his middle linebacker position. second and nine for the Knights. Campbell out of the fullback position, running room to the five, bulls forward. He's got a first down at the 3 yard line.
Jack Campbell is really rolling here in the third quarter. I'll tell you, I like this play, little scissors play. And IC is really rolling right now. You're gonna see Jack Campbell come right here, a little counter action. He's gonna get back upfield. Watch him lower that shoulder. And he's just trying to run people over. IC now has it first and goal from about the, what, 3 yard line, Jim?
At the three, 11 yard run and a first down for Campbell. This drive for IC started at their own 49. Now they have it first and goal at the three. Campbell bullying up the middle. He's close, but he did not get in. 1 minute to go, third quarter. Immaculate Conception 1 yard away from a potential tying score. We know that Schreiber is nearly automatic on conversions. You would think they would probably kick here if they score and try to tie the game up.
Exactly.
From inside the 1 yard line, the Knights up to the line of scrimmage. Second down, goal to go. Schreiber takes quarterback sneak. He surges forward. Touchdown for the Knights.
Second, third effort, got him in there. He took a chance sticking that ball out like that. Anthony Schreiber is able to get it over the goal line, and now they're just a PAT away from tying this football game up.
Schreiber with his 12th rushing touchdown of the year, a 51-yard scoring drive for Immaculate Conception. 30 seconds left to go in the third quarter, and we have got a dandy of a state championship here in Class 3A. It'll be Schreiber, who is 36 for 38 on conversions this year, trying to tie it up out of the hold of Joe Mastrino. Kicking it to the south end zone.
Ooh,
and the
go.
Kick is not gonna get there. It came up short. Do you believe that?
No, just a minute, you talk about how consistent he's been all year. He misses one right there. I'll tell you, he hit that a little fat, like he hit a wedge, he hit it fat.
Yep,
he
like
kicked
my,
the
it's
team.
Like my wedge.
Like your wedge. He just missed a lot of the football.
All right, 30 seconds to go. Third quarter, DuQuoin maintains the lead, 14-13. Let's take a timeout here on the IHSA Television Network. The 2002 IHSA Girls Volleyball Champions have been crowned, and the exciting title matchups are coming your way on the AT&T Broadband Network Monday, December 9th at 7 p.m. 2.5 hours of championship volleyball, beginning with the Class A Mount Pulaski Wheaton St. Francis showdown, followed by the AA clash between Barrington and Downers Grove South. Additional airings and channel locations do vary, so be sure to log on to attbroadbandnetwork.com for scheduling and channel information in your area. For more information, call 630-260-5304. Games are not available in some areas. All right, Immaculate Conception, 1 point away from tying it up, and they miss on the conversion. And now they have to kick off, and DuQuoin will get it, working into the wind for just 30 more seconds here in the third quarter.
We have ourselves a football game. I'll tell you what, this one is really tightened up, and you can see the momentum shifting to IC here in this third quarter.
Deep kick on the return for DuQuoin. Cody Ellemeyer looking for the far sideline. He's got it to the 30 to the 32-yard line. Ellemeyer with a pretty good return of 21 yards, and DuQuoin will take over on offense. Their offense has gone away since the first quarter.
Well, it really has. You know, we talked about what Al Martin wanted to do, mixing it up a little bit. They've stayed basically with the run here in the third quarter. I'd like to see him go to the air a little bit. I know the wind's into him, but you still have to keep that defense honest.
DuQuoin had about 130 yards of offense in the first quarter. They have about 50 or 60 yards of offense since then. 21 seconds to go in the third. DuQuoin leading Immaculate Conception 14-13. And DuQuoin will line up in the wishbone as you see quarterback Nick Hill duck under center. He's gonna throw, flushed out of the pocket. The lefty airs it out down the field. Almost a great catch by Jordan Campanella. He comes up empty and second down and 10 upcoming.
Boy, his first read right there was to go downfield to Terrence Spiller, but IC jumped into a little double coverage on him. Hill came back, and Campanella couldn't hang on to it. But this is a nice throw and almost a great catch. You're gonna see quarterback Mark Hill just Nick Hill, I'm sorry, come all the way out here. And Jordan Campanella gets one of those big paws up right there. Just can't bring it in. That would have been a great catch.
15 seconds to go, third quarter. 15 yards of offense for DuQuoin here in the third quarter. Nick Hill on the option, pitches back and it's gonna go nowhere. Beard the ball carrier and the speed of this Immaculate Conception team offensively and defensively is really starting to show now.
Well, they're playing with a little bit of an attitude right now. I seem they came in, they were a little bit lethargic, and now they're playing with some attitude on defense, flying around what I thought they were going to do. I saw them a week ago play against Wilmington. I hadn't seen a better defense all year in 3A, and now I'm seeing that, what I saw last week against Wilmington.
So third and 10 for DuQuoin. The Indians are 3-for-8 on third down here tonight, and this is third and long with 7 seconds to go in the third quarter. Out of the wishbone. They take and they give it up the middle to Robbie Tilley. Tilley gets to the 35-yard line. He needed to get to the 43 to get a first down, and that was the final play of quarter number three. Three quarters in the books here in the Class 3A state championship game, and we have got a dandy right now with DuQuoin leading Immaculate Conception 14-13 is the score. Indians by one as we go to a local timeout. From crowning a champion in Class 3A, DuQuoin on top of Immaculate Conception 14-13. And DuQuoin in a punting situation, 4th and 7. As we start the fourth quarter, it'll be Derek Beard, not a punt, with the wind at his back. DuQuoin to boot it, and Beard gets it away. Line drive kick. It's gonna bounce, and IC lets it roll dead at about the 32-yard line. For Derek Beard, a punt of 32 yards, no return. And IC will take over on offense, down by 1 point.
Yeah, an offense that's really been moving here in the second half.
Right now, let's go back down to the field. Mike Kleff is standing by once again.
The Colts defense, it seemed like they were on the field virtually the entire third quarter. And their defensive linemen have to be really tired chasing around Anthony Shriver. That's something definitely to keep an eye on during this drive. Back to you guys.
I'm sure Shriver wants to atone for missing the extra point. So he'll be trying to make some plays here, no doubt about it. We've got a whistle, and boy, Immaculate Conception is going to have to burn their first time out of the second half before we even run a play here in the fourth quarter. 11:49 to go in the game, and we're gonna take a break. We'll have more from the IHSA Television Network after these messages. From Memorial Stadium in Champaign, Immaculate Conception with the ball, trailing 14-13. IC takes over on this drive from their own 32-yard line, 1st and 10. Three receivers in the formation. Shriver looking to throw. The lefty stops, hit as he throws, airs it out deep down the field, the ball overthrown and incomplete, intended for Joe Mastrino. Good pressure applied by the DuQuoin defense, and I think that Shriver probably threw that a little bit before he really wanted to.
Yeah, he did, exactly. He was waiting for Mastrino to break a little bit quicker. We're gonna see the replay right here on the sprint out, and this is a play that Shriver's had a lot of success with all year. This one, he just overshoots Mastrino. He did have a step there right at the end of the play.
Once again, it was Jordan Campanella who's played a great game out of his defensive end position that applied the pressure to Anthony Shriver. There you see Shriver duck in. And they're going to give it to the fullback. That's Campbell again. And about a 5-yard run for Jack Campbell to bring up 3rd and 5.
But Jack Campbell's picked it up here in the second half. That was his 10th carry for 41 yards. So he's had a nice half here. In the second half.
And Campbell's only a junior, 6-foot, 190-pound junior running back. Both Immaculate Conception and DuQuoin playing for the championship with just one loss this season. DuQuoin losing to Heron back in week 3. And IC losing to Driscoll, who earlier tonight won the 4A title in week 9. Third down, Shriver looking to throw on the run, airs it out, and the pass is going to be what?
Caught, but he's going to be short about the line of scrimmage, actually.
Yeah, actually, it might be a loss on the play. The pass was caught by 44, Gabe Murphy. Loss on the play to bring up fourth down long. Loss of a couple.
Yeah, Shriver's actually trying to go downfield with this. From this angle, we will not be able to see it, but he wants to hit Mastrino again down the sideline. Can't. Tries to make a play right here. Gabe Murphy is open, but not enough for the first down.
So fourth down, and IC will punt. High snap. The kick nearly blocked again, but it's away. It's going to sail out of bounds along the near sideline, and they're going to mark it at the 30, 41, 42, 43, 44, 44-yard line. And the official walking up the sideline, and he marks it at the 44.
That wasn't Schreiber punting right there, as Matt Jaswiak punting. I saw that a few times last week against Wilmington. Jaswiak would actually come in and kick or punt if Shriver needed to come out and take a break.
Just a 21-yard kick into the wind, and DuQuoin leading by one with the ball. Good field position from their own 44-yard line.
Yeah, best field position of this half, no doubt about it.
Nick Hill has only thrown for 47 yards in the ball game. Now he has the wind in his back. Nick Hill in the middle, the ball came loose. It's going to be IC football.
David Suarez, number 70, the center. I told you they put him in at middle guard right there. He's made a lot of nice plays. They've actually taken out Bill Bianchi, number 61. We're going to see Suarez from his nose guard position. They actually double team him. He gets off that block and is able to come up with the football.
A bad exchange between Hill and Endress. Right. That is the first turnover for either team. It comes at the 10:04 mark of the fourth quarter, and IC down by one with great field position at the DuQuoin 44-yard line. Shriver gives it to Mastrino. He's cut down a short pickup on the play. He got about 3, second and 7, upcoming for Immaculate Conception.
Boy, then he was drilled by Chad Wilson. He's 5'11", 167, and a sophomore. Nice player from his outside linebacker position.
Mastrino is one of those Barry Sanders-type runners. You keep giving him the ball because at any time, he's capable of going the distance.
Exactly right.
Both he and Shriver were 4-event state track meet qualifiers last year. Here's Mastrino again. Hit at the line, falls forward for a little bit on the play to bring up third down. Clock going with 9:22 to go in the game.
He does have a little Barry Sanders in him as well, doesn't he? You know, he stops on a dime, jets to left or right. I like how he runs the football. But it's a big third down right here. Third and about 6.
Third and a long 5 as we reach the 9-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Immaculate Conception, third and 5 from the DuQuoin 39-yard line. A give up the middle to Tim Mastrino, number 33. Mastrino slithers forward to about the 35-yard line.
It might have been Jack Campbell.
It was Campbell
sure.
Again.
Was
my mistake. It was Campbell. Campbell with the carry, and he's going to bring up fourth and short. Fourth and 1 upcoming for Immaculate Conception. And I see 1 for 3 on fourth down here tonight. This is the shortest fourth down that they've gone for. There you see Coach Bob Cozy shouting instructions to his offense. They no doubt will go for it. Down by 1 with 8:12 to go in the quarter. Campbell up the middle, first down for the Knights.
Wow, what a save by the offensive line right there.
The ball came loose, and it's Beard running the other direction with it. You see him there, but the play was ruled down.
You know, you really didn't hear a whistle or see the officials moving their arms like the ball was dead. You did see one official running down the field with the ball carrier, but they're gonna blow it dead.
8:07 to go in the fourth quarter.
Here's the replay right here. See the handoff to Jack Campbell. He did get the first down. It did look like his knees were on the ground before that football came out.
Yeah, he was down. And a big first down for Immaculate Conception, their 10th of the game. Schreiber to throw. Steps up in the pocket. Run. Schreiber trying to get the corner. He does to the 25, and he races out of bounds at the 23. It's a pickup of about 8 yards to bring up second and short for Immaculate Conception.
He's got a little smarter since that first half. He took a few vicious hits there in the first half. This one, he gets his, picks up his 8 or 9 yards, then steps out of bounds and doesn't take the big hit. There you get a good look of Anthony Schreiber right there. What a player he is.
Schreiber and Illinois Football Coaches Association All-Stater. Both these quarterbacks in this game were All-Staters. Give up the middle. Campbell, the fullback, once again is going to get the first down. Jack Campbell continues to get those tough yards up the middle. Another first down for IC. And IC has now out first down DuQuoin 11-8. In the ball game. DuQuoin had a decided advantage in that early on.
Yeah, exactly right. I got to give a lot of credit to that front five of Immaculate Conception. Patrick Gibbons, Bill Kreft, David Suarez, Victor Corral, and Ryan Zarante. They are really getting after it here in the second half.
Campbell up the middle, again some tough yardage as he surges forward to around the 16-yard line. Second and seven upcoming.
It seems like Immaculate Conception is now getting to the defensive linebackers. At first they weren't able to, you know, block Endress and Chad Wilson. We were calling their name a lot with all the tackles, but all of a sudden now the offensive line is getting to that second level, getting those linebackers on the ground, and that's why Jack Campbell's having so much success.
Second and seven. Schreiber takes. Mastrino hit at the line and he falls forward for a short gain on the play. Third down upcoming. And even though Immaculate Conception is moving into the wind, you have to remember that Anthony Schreiber is 11 for 15 in field goal attempts this year. So a field goal here would give IC the lead. But they're looking for the touchdown on third down and four. There you see Al Martin, a look of concern on his face. Third and four for the Knights. Schreiber gives it to Campbell, up the middle, spinning forward, he's got the first down. It's gonna be first and goal for Immaculate Conception.
Campbell again, the ball carrier.
Boy, Campbell did a great job of running through the tackles. Bryce Marks, number 74, he's 6'2 and about 209. Campbell ran right through it.
There you just saw Bob Cozy. He gave the first down signal. Very, very happy right now. His team has the ball at the DuQuoin 6-yard line, 6 minutes to go in this championship game. IC down by one, but there goes to the end zone. Schreiber rolling near side. He wants to run to the 5. He hurdles and gets down to about the 2. Second down, goal to go coming up after the 4-yard run.
Well, that's called selling out right there. He just tried to stick that football in there. There you see Coach Cozy again. He might go back to that same play again. We're going to see the replay. This is a predetermined run right here by Anthony Schreiber. He's not even really looking to pass. You see those fullbacks and running backs locking on. Schreiber does a great job getting down to the 2-yard line.
I'm telling you, if I'm the coach, I'm giving the ball to my All-Stater and saying make a play.
There you go, exactly.
Schreiber gives it to Mastrino. He dives for a touchdown. Joe Mastrino goes in from 2 yards out, and Immaculate Conception with a 19-14 lead, and they will probably go for 2.
Yeah, I like this call right here. Give the ball to the back, deep in the backfield, let him pick the seam, and he picks the right one as Joe Mastrino gets in for the touchdown. Now IC will go for 2, up 19-14. Well, no, it looks like they're actually going to kick.
Mastrino with his 11th rushing touchdown of the year. They're going to fake. Now they're going to go for 2. Schreiber to the end zone, and he is going to get in. Schreiber lined up to kick the conversion. They fake it, and Schreiber takes it in for 2. It's now 21-14 in favor of IC.
Yeah, he takes it in and takes out one of the cameramen there on the sideline. What a great call right there. Gutsy call by Coach Cozy. As the guy that was actually going to hold the snap flips it back over to his shoulder, and with, you know, Schreiber being so athletic, let him just make a play, and he did. Well, look at that sideline. They are just pumped up.
Remember, DuQuoin at one point led this game 14-0. At one point, it was 14-0. At one point, DuQuoin was up 14-0. Now, Immaculate Conception with the lead, 21-14, with 5:43 to go in the game.
Wow, you can hear those fans now from IC. When I went to that game, I think I told you, the Wilmington IC game, I've never seen fans like theirs. They brought their own PA system. They brought everything. I mean, they had more banners and fans than I've ever seen. They were a pumped up group. And I tell you, I didn't hear them for the first half of this game, but all of a sudden, they're back into the game. And I'll tell you, that really helps their players. Now with 5:43 left, up 21-14.
Jazz React with the deep kick, fielded at the 10. Up the middle, 25-30, running room for Spiller as he carries all the way out to the 40-yard line. On the kickoff return, Terrence Spiller goes 30 yards. Here is the IC touchdown once again.
That's right. We'll see Joe Mastrino, number two, get the ball real deep in the backfield, just dive in there. Good blocking by the left side of that offensive line.
So the Immaculate, and there's the reaction from head coach Bob Cozy.
Thinks he's into the football game a little bit.
You gotta love that enthusiasm. Oh,
I love that.
And here's the fake on the two-point conversion. They just flipped it to Schreiber, and he took off around the corner to the left side and nails one of the cameramen. A pass down the field is going to be caught, making the catch Beard for DuQuoin. And it is going to be a gain inside the 40 of Immaculate Conception territory, a pickup of 22 yards for the Indians. Beard making the reception. And it's a first down for the Indians inside of Immaculate Conception territory. Hill with the 23-yard pass to Derek Beard.
He was open the whole way. Hill could have thrown it to him a lot earlier, didn't see him. I think he was actually looking to his left to throw, and then Beard just stayed open, found the open seam, and Hill hit him.
The ball at the 37 in Immaculate Conception territory. Hill looking to throw. Now he's going to run to the 35, and he's going to go out of bounds around the 33. Pick up of around 4 yards on the play. Clock stops with 5:01 to play fourth quarter, and the lead is 21-14 Immaculate Conception. And we have an injured IC player. It is number 70, David Suarez is injured.
He has had a great half here this second half. We talked about him playing nose guard. He is also their center. So we'll have to keep an eye out to see who they bring in. We're going to get a replay of that last play. Maybe we can catch to see how he is injured on this play. As Hill rolls out, can't really see how he's injured. Hill does get out of bounds. Stop the clock here on second down.
So there you see Suarez still being tended to by the training staff for the Knights. And they're going to help him up. That's always good to see.
It's a good sign. 6'2", 230, and a senior. He's been through the wars a few times. I wouldn't be surprised. We'll see him back.
And here we will see what happened on the injury on this replay.
Yeah, keep an eye right there on number 70, right there. Gets his right knee cut out from underneath of him. And a very legal block, but Suarez was injured on the play.
Hill to throw again. He's gonna air it out, looking toward the end zone. The ball tipped away at the last moment. Spiller was open, the ball a little bit underthrown, and it was tipped away by Murphy.
Geez, what a play. And that was a good throw, actually. Hill, I thought initially it was going to be underthrown, but Gabe Murphy, he just made a great play. Got a hand up and knocked the football down. That's what I wanted to see DuQuoin do a little bit more of, throw that ball down the field to Spiller. I love watching him run.
4:55 to go in the fourth quarter. DuQuoin down 21-14. They're faced with 3rd and 6 at the Immaculate Conception 33. Come the Indians up to the line of scrimmage. Their All-State quarterback, the left-hander Nick Hill, under center. Hill looking to throw again. Chase down from behind, gets rid of it just in time to avoid the sack. So fourth down is upcoming for DuQuoin. Huge play here with 4:47 left. DuQuoin still has 3 timeouts left. The Indians inside of IC territory, down by a touchdown.
Boy, that was a great play right there by number 11, Kevin Mulligan, from his linebacker position, came on an inside blitz and was able to get to Nick Hill and force him to throw it before he actually wanted to.
just a second too late, or that would have been a big sack.
Right.
And now here comes DuQuoin up to the line of scrimmage. DuQuoin 0 for 1 on fourth down tonight. Fourth and 6 at the Immaculate Conception 33-yard line. Hill to throw, flushed out of the pocket, and he is going to get rid of it just in time, but the ball is dropped by Beard. The ball was dropped, and DuQuoin turns it over on downs with 4:41 left to go.
There you see Derek Beard. He knows he should have caught that ball. He had some running room. If he does catch that ball, I don't know if he would have gotten the first down, but he did have some running room and maybe could have made it a play and got the first down, but it didn't happen. And now IC with 4:41 here in the fourth quarter, they will have the ball about the 33-yard line.
And Immaculate Conception obviously just trying to run some clock here. DuQuoin does have timeouts to burn on defense.
We have all three of them left.
Shriver up the middle, Murphy. Murphy with some, Jack Campbell with the carry. It's Gabe Murphy, Jack Campbell.
Right, two pretty good fullbacks, no doubt about that.
4:25 to go. Campbell now with 16 carries for 66 yards.
Right.
Second down and about 7 for Immaculate Conception. Campbell and Murphy in the eye. Play clock down to 8 as Shriver takes his time. Murphy hitting the backfield and dropped. Third down and long is upcoming. And will DuQuoin burn a timeout here with 3:50 to go?
I don't think you have to yet.
Not yet.
That was a nice hit by number 74, I believe that was, from DuQuoin. Bryce Marks there from his defensive tackle position on the fullback. This is a big play right here. I think he could burn a first down or burn a timeout if Immaculate Conception is not able to get the first down. You may want to burn one right now. Then your offense will get the ball. A lot of time left. 3.5 minutes still left in this football game.
So Immaculate Conception 4 for 12 on third down. Rolling right. Shriver airs it out. And it's caught by Campbell. He's got the first down and more. He might go the distance. Campbell to the 30, to the 20. Penalty flag on the play. Way back near the line of scrimmage. And then a penalty flag at the end of the play as well. This might be coming back. If it stands, it's a 53-yard pass reception for Jack Campbell.
No doubt about it. They're going to get number 3, Dan Howard, on a clip after the reception. What a great job by the quarterback right there. Anthony Shriver does a good job getting the ball to the fullback quickly. Let him make a play. We didn't see the clip right there. Just a little bit to the side you did, and this one is going to come back. Might have had a face mask there as well.
Face mask at the end of the play, maybe. Now, if the clip, well, Immaculate Conception reacting like it is going to be on DuQuoin. Let's find out.
We have a block in the back, on the blue, on the run. At the end of the run, we had a 5-yard face mask on the white. Those penalties are offsetting. We will replay the down.
Well, that is a break for DuQuoin.
Because yeah, without a doubt.
It went from a 53-yard gain. Now they have to run 3rd and 7 again with 3:05 to go in the fourth quarter.
Now let's see if we can see the replay again. Maybe we could see the illegal block in the back. Watch to the left of your screen. After the reception, you're gonna see number 44 get hit in the back by number 3. That was a great camera angle right there. And that was an excellent call by the official. And there's your face mask at the end of the run. Those penalties offset. Now we have 3rd and 7 here with 2:47 left in the fourth quarter.
Shriver rolling near side. He wants to run. Shriver has got the first down out across the 45 to the 46-yard line. A big first down for the Knights. And now DuQuoin will have to start burning timeouts on defense to preserve some clock here.
Yeah, the first down will stop the clock, as this is a predetermined run once again. They just want to get their best athlete on the field and have him run the football. He's got to drive you nuts as a coach, though. Look how he has that football out like that.
but he hasn't had a problem turning it over as Anthony Schreiber picks up a huge first down.
So Immaculate Conception with the lead by 7. They just converted on a big 3rd and 7. They're now 5 of 13. And
after the play.
Wow. A personal foul called on the IC bench after the play. So they'll get the first down, but it'll cost them 15 yards.
Boy, that's huge. That is huge. You don't see that call very often.
Well, you see head coach Bob Cozy obviously not happy with what is going on right now. Certainly happy with the scoreboard. He'd like that clock to be reading 0-0-0 right now instead of 2:36.
And 10 yards.
So it'll be 1st and 10 for Immaculate Conception. And the ball will go back to the 31-yard line for the Knights inside of their own territory. There you see Bianchi, and apparently the penalty was called on Bianchi.
It must have been, and Coach Cozy's not very happy about that.
1st and 10. There you see Murphy with the carry, and DuQuoin will take a quick timeout.
Well, I think they called it off. They're not going to take one. Maybe they'll take one here on 2nd down if they're able to stop them. They really have to start thinking about stopping this clock.
2nd and 8 coming up. Gabe Murphy just picked up a couple there. Clock continues to roll. Down to 2:10 left to play, 4th quarter. With Immaculate Conception leading DuQuoin 21-14. DuQuoin with all of its points in the first quarter. Immaculate Conception with 7 in the second, 6 in the third, and 8 here in the fourth. 2nd and 8. Schreiber right up the middle on the run, gets across the 35 to the 36, and now DuQuoin will take a timeout. 1:46 to go here in the fourth quarter, and we're going to take a timeout. It's a network timeout. Huge play upcoming. 3rd down, and the scoreboard here at Memorial Stadium says 5 yards to go for Immaculate Conception. There you see 1:46 to play in the fourth quarter. DuQuoin still has 2 timeouts left, but they need to make a stop right here. Schreiber rolling right. He wants to run. Schreiber is going to get the first down as he slides near midfield and goes down. The clock will stop to move the chains. What a huge run by Schreiber. We're seeing why he's an All-Stater.
No doubt about it. Did a great job sliding and staying inbound. As you mentioned, the clock will stop to move the chains, but it will start on the official signal. Here's the replay one more time. We've seen this play a few times. The predetermined roll by Schreiber just gets outside. Watch the slide at the end. That's smart. That's being a senior quarterback and one of the captains and one of the leaders of this football team.
Schreiber was a wide receiver most of the time last year as a junior. He started the first game at quarterback, played 2 series, didn't play well, didn't play quarterback again for the rest of the season. DuQuoin will jump off sides here. I don't think they were drawn off.
Yeah, it looked like number 64 may have moved Bill Kreft, I believe, from his left guard position.
False start, offense. So first down.
So they were drawn offside, so it becomes 1st and 15. DuQuoin still has 2 timeouts to burn. 1:16 on the fourth quarter clock. There you see Gary Henson, our referee.
Timeout.
And Immaculate Conception will take a timeout here. This officiating crew has done a great job tonight.
Fans remain in their seats for the award ceremony, which will take place immediately after the game on the platform in front of the horseshoe at the south end of Memorial Stadium.
There's head coach Bob Cozy for Immaculate Conception. This copyrighted broadcast is presented for the exclusive entertainment and non-commercial use of our audience. Any reproduction, rebroadcast, or other use of this program without the expressed written consent of the Illinois High School Association and cost broadcast sales is strictly prohibited. In his first year as head coach, you just saw Bob Cozy. He's 1:16 from leading his team to the promised land in a state championship. We told you earlier, ironically, for DuQuoin coach Al Martin in his first year, You see him right there. He led his team to a state championship.
That's right. He knows what it feels like to go through your first football season with players, you know, wanting to figure, trying to figure out the coaching staff as well. And then to win a state championship, that's got to be incredible.
First and 15. So give up the middle. And DuQuoin will take a timeout. A few seconds rolled off the clock. We're down to 1:11. It's going to be second down and 13. Campbell again with the carry, his 17th carry of the game. And Campbell has been a ton for Immaculate Conception here in the second half.
Yeah, if you're looking for most valuable players of this game, he could definitely be considered one of them. I know Anthony Schreiber, the quarterback, defensive back, will definitely be considered as well. But Jack Campbell has just been phenomenal.
Campbell with 17 carries for 67 yards. Anthony Schreiber, the quarterback, 16 carries for 72 yards. Schreiber leading the team in rushing. There you see that both teams have one timeout remaining, 1:11 on the clock. It'll be second down, and DuQuoin can stop the clock one more time.
Yeah, this last minute and a half may take a half hour, the way it's going with all these timeouts and first down, so.
Immaculate Conception came out a little sluggish in the first quarter. DuQuoin hit them hard with a couple of long drives to start the game. DuQuoin led 14-0 in the first quarter, if you're just joining us, and Immaculate Conception has scored touchdowns in each of the second, third, and fourth quarters to pull back on top, and they're 1:11 away from a state championship. Second down and 13, out of the timeout. Shriver is gonna keep it. Tries to stay in bounds, and he does. A penalty flag came in on the play. We're looking at holding probably on Immaculate Conception with 1:06 to go in the ball game.
Looks like they threw that flag right at the feet of Ryan Zarante, the 6'3", 210-pound senior. It is going to be a hold. Let's see what Al Martin and the staff want to do with this one.
I think you have to decline it and take the down, don't you?
Yeah, I really do. Exactly.
Because it would make it third down in around 10.
Holding. Offense. At penalties decline.
Good call.
Third down.
So now they'll wind the clock. Schreiber managed to stay in bounds. So once the ball is marked ready for play, as you see the replay here.
See the flag flash across the top of the screen right there. And good call by Al Martin and his staff not to accept that penalty.
So the clock is rolling. DuQuoin does have a timeout to take. They're not going to take it right now. 50 seconds to go. Third down. And DuQuoin will take the timeout if they hold right here. Immaculate Conception, third and long. Gabe Murphy with the carry. Surges forward, and he's going to be close to the first down. If he got it, it looks like he might. That would just about do it for the Knights.
Yep, they're already moving the chains. The indication is there. That is a first down. Boy, you just see how happy those players they are. Anthony Schreiber being one of them. A lot of seniors on this football team. Got to be happy for them.
Immaculate Conception was 4-for-12 on third down before this drive started. They're 3-for-3 on third down in this drive, which could be a championship clinching drive. Looks like they're gonna go to the victory formation and run the clock out. They take the snap, Schreiber goes to a knee. DuQuoin is not gonna take a timeout, and that is gonna do it as the clock will wind down to zero, and the Suburban Catholic Conference is going to have its second state champion crowned here at Memorial Stadium tonight. Addison Driscoll did it in 4A, and now Elmhurst, Immaculate Conception, has done it in Class 3A. You see Coach Bob Posey getting a bear hug there a moment ago. You gotta love that jubilation.
Oh, you gotta love it. Anthony Schreiber goes over to the officials and said, I want that football. That baby's going on my mantle or at the school. And boy, what a great group of guys. What a great victory for them. Come from behind victory when it looked like they were gonna get blown out of this football game.
DuQuoin jumping out to the early lead, 14-0 in the first quarter. And then the IC defense really stepped up and gave their offense time to start the rally. And yeah, there's the key right there.
Yeah, we've talked so much about the offense. Let's give some credit to that defense. They finally sucked it up and said, hey, man, we've got to stop these guys a little bit, give our offense a chance. They did.
Their offense was able to respond, put 21 points on the board after going 14 down for the big victory in the 3A state championship.
We'll look at all the stats a little bit later on, but here's a big one. At halftime, time of possession was pretty even. But right now, when it's all said and done, time of possession for Immaculate Conception, 29 minutes and 16 seconds compared to just 18:44 for DuQuoin.
No doubt about it. That offense really took over, and the defense was able to stop them, get that ball back to the offense. I just think it was a total team effort. Everybody did their part and couldn't be happier for Immaculate Conception. But, man, DuQuoin, they played their hearts out as well.
We said one of the keys for DuQuoin was to limit big plays. DuQuoin limited the big plays, but Immaculate Conception, they win the game, kind of grinding it out, playing some power football. Right now, let's go down to the field. Mike Kleff is standing by down on Memorial Stadium's turf.
All right, we are with the state championship coach, Bob Cozy. State championship.
Would you say that again, please?
State championship.
Thank you very much. That's the greatest thing I've heard in a long, long time. I'll tell you, my kids are resilient. We played a lousy first half. We challenged them at halftime. I can't say enough about my offense and defensive coordinators. They did an outstanding job, I'll tell you. I'm so proud of these kids. My gosh.
Bob, I'll tell you what, we got a guy we're going to talk to in a moment.
That's good.
Great players make great plays, and you've got one in quarterback Anthony Schreiner.
Well, we sure do. He's All-State. And we put the ball in his hands in the fourth quarter, and that's what did it.
You know, the other thing, Bob, your defense, after those first couple of early drives by DuQuoin, they were sensational.
Yeah, we knew we did not play good defensively, especially in that first quarter. And we challenged those guys at halftime. And this kid, we gave him the ball in the second half. Take your helmet off so that people can see your handsome face.
Anthony Schreiber, man, is this better than you ever would have even thought of it?
It was the most amazing feeling we've ever experienced. I can't explain it. I can't.
Seriously, what are you guys talking about on the sidelines when you're down early, 14-0?
I mean, we knew, you know, it's a state championship game, so we knew we were going to be down. We had to pick our heads up, and we sucked it up and got it done.
What can you say about this guy?
He's a great man. I love him. I love him like my own dad.
Could you have imagined a first season as a head coach going any better than this? And you told me at halftime these kids have responded all year.
Yes, they have. We've challenged them all year. We handled adversity after the Driscoll loss. Wilmington was the toughest place in the world to play. I knew they were coming back. You guys need to come with me, okay?
Okay, we'll be there, Bob. Congratulations. Bob Cozy, head coach of state championship team, Immaculate Conception. Back up to the booth, guys, right after these messages.
They're okay, I think.
That's 1A title game, 21-14 in favor of Immaculate Conception. DuQuoin on your screen right now, receiving their second place trophy. A great season for Coach Al Martin and the Indians. But they could not hold on to a 14-point first quarter lead, and they end up with a final record of 12-2. And Immaculate Conception, in their first ever appearance in a state title game, will be crowned champions. They're being crowned champions right now. And you know why? Because of their defense. Defense shut down DuQuoin in the second half.
Exactly. You just saw Bob Cozy receive his medal. Man, I think he'll probably wear that all week, maybe all month. What a fantastic effort his staff did. He gave a lot of credit to his offensive defensive coordinator, and rightly so. They put together a great game plan, and we can't forget how well DuQuoin played as well, Jim. They played outstanding. They had an excellent game plan as well, and I was very impressed by both these Class 3A football.